I be telling them to do that to my beard too.
You know, yeah,
what now?
What now? My beard.
Yo, who? Yo,
my beard.
When does that happen?
My beard. I cut it.
Alternate universe.
You know that is velcroed onto your fucking lip, nigga. I've been looking at that shit all night, and I'm like, I know that shit finna melt off. If he get too hot, that's it. He got double stick tape on some coochie hairs.
That's why it's so cold in here.
You got coochie hairs.
Oh, man. All right, let's do this.
Yo, this is Nappy Boy Radio.
Yo, this is
Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Live with your boy, T-Pain.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I am your homeboy, T-Pain, a.k.a. your girlfriend's boyfriend.
And I am your boy, Pip, a.k.a. Mr. Fresh Prince, a.k.a. Mr. God Damn.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a great show for you tonight. Guess why I keep saying that, Pip?
Why?
I don't know. It's not getting better.
It is. I think it is.
You think so?
I do.
Okay. I mean, the guests are getting better. I'm not getting better at this at all.
I'm definitely getting worse. The last shit.
Woo. Yeah, we were drunk.
Damn,
what happened? Y'all was drunk.
I don't know. I don't edit these in order, so that's a good thing. We can talk about that. But without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, she is ready as always. Give it up for Tiffany.
Come and get your baby daddy.
How you doing?
I'm successful.
Oh, that's so good to hear. Let's not forget, come on now.
This is my friend. She's a singer, songwriter. And her name is PJ.
Yes, ma'am.
Do people call you Peach?
Yes.
Lit. That's me for tonight. I'm calling Peach. Yeah,
Peach.
That's good.
Peach.
But nah. So you've been successful.
Mm-hmm.
You've been ready.
Mm-hmm.
You've been on. You've been doing a lot.
Have I?
It's how do you do so much?
Scheduling.
Nice.
You planning?
I'm not good at
it's
that.
It's all strategy, babe.
Mm-mm.
You want to play chess? I'm gonna whoop that ass.
Okay, you know what? I only know like two of the rules of chess. I don't know which way some of the pieces go.
I learned how to play chess from Dope Dealers, and so that's how it
okay.
broke it down to me.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
I played chess one time against a bunch of Cubans, and that didn't work out well
Queen
at all.
Off.
Yeah, it was not. It was unsuccessful, which is why I stopped. I'll tell you this. The most important question we ask on the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast: how is your mental health these days?
My mental health is pretty good. Now, if you would have asked me that a month and a half ago, I'd have been like, it's bad, bro. My mental health is not where it need to be. I'm crying every other day and all this. But I'm good now.
Okay. Was it bad to where you kind of had control over it and you chose not to control it? Or was it just like, shit was just fucking up back to back and there was nothing you can do?
Shit was fucking up back to back. Nothing I could do, but I had control over me. I had control over me. I had control over my thoughts. I have control over how I respond to things.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people react, and I think that's the wrong way to go about it.
Okay.
Reacting is when you don't have control, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
I responded.
Mm-hmm. Come on, come
mm-hmm.
on,
I'm a
come
responder.
On.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I might be a rescuer. You,
right.
you might need to call me a rescue ranger,
first,
goddamn.
First,
you know
first responder. Let's
I'm
go.
First responder for me. I'm a first responder for me. Okay.
All right.
I control my mind. I have to tell my mind all the time. You not in control of this. I control you, mind. And that's my soul talking to my mind.
Soul to the mind.
Yeah, we argue.
Yes.
Do you have a therapist?
Yes, I do have a therapist. Yep. And from, I would say, starting back in December till probably about 3 weeks ago, I was talking to them every day. I definitely was getting on their nerve. My bill was high.
How about that?
My bill
about
that
high?
Bill, too.
My bill was high.
God.
My bill was high. I was like, oh, wait, bitch.
Yeah.
People pay to talk to me.
Right.
How much I got to pay this much to talk to you?
I feel like it should be a trade at some point.
Yeah.
It should be like, I'm going to charge you for just talking
right.
here.
Laughing
or at
least
my
pay.
Tell them, yo, I got these famous people that I do. I'd give y'all a discount if y'all come here.
Boom. If you get like a referral fee or something. Yeah. If you bring more people in there, you get some off of your bill.
Yeah, no. You know, I don't want to share them though, cause I want them to be accessible to me.
They just gonna start talking about you together.
Yeah, I know, right? Right? Be like, so Tiffany told me about you. Yeah. Oh, Tiffany. Oh, you know what Tiffany be doing to me? Yeah, Tiffany. Blah, blah. You know what? She is crazy like that. You know, Tiffany told me a story about this one time. Nah, I'm cool.
That's fucked up. How did you start? But how does therapy start? I believe in therapy. I just don't have the time or the scheduling or the organization you have. How, like, what is it? What is it like going into therapy that first time? Like, all right, what the fuck you want me to say?
Okay, you have to remember, first time I went into therapy, I was like 15 years old.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I was in foster care. So it was like court ordered to go.
Oh.
So and my first time going, I just colored. Now I just colored in the coloring book and they asked me questions and I just looked at them and I colored.
Oh, so it was like a movie.
They're trying to distract you.
Yeah. And I did, then I, next time I went, I did a puzzle and then I said a little bit of this, a little bit of that. And the next time I went, I just started telling all the business.
Okay.
I told all the damn business. I told it all because that's what I do. I can't hold shit. Don't commit no crime with me because I'm telling it all.
Come on, nigga. Come on out, man. They got us.
That's why they won't let me be here. Yeah, come on.
Oh, we
this
going
why
to
I'll
jail.
Never be in the Illuminati because I'll tell how everything went down.
I keep telling people that. They won't let me in. They know I'm going to tell. I'm going to tell everybody.
I don't want to be in.
I'm too real. I'll get in there. Let me get in there for a couple years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the trial period?
I remember that one time you was like, shit, I wish they would ask me to be in one. I'm like, hell yeah,
hell
I'm coming.
Yeah. Because everybody that people keep saying is in the Illuminati is rich as a motherfucker.
Yeah,
I want to be in that bitch too. If you're telling me I'm in there, what the fuck is that? What's the pay gap?
But are they happy though?
I don't know.
But are they happy?
The Illuminati don't let you get seen unhappy.
I don't know.
You start fucking around apparently. Goddamn shit. I don't know what it is, but
I'd rather be happy.
Apparently, it's full of black people because white people don't need the Illuminati apparently. Nah. None of the death metal bands, none of the people that openly worship the devil, none of them people are in the Illuminati. But a nigga get rich, oh yeah, that's the devil.
In Illuminati.
That's the devil. I don't understand it. But I mean, it's good. Okay, so when you went to therapy as an adult, voluntarily.
Yeah.
What was that situation like? Because
The first time I went voluntarily, I had basically had a full-on breakdown. I was like 21.
Okay.
And I had a full-on breakdown. My body was breaking down. My heart was broke. Everything was broke. I was like on some like, I'm ready to jump off the bridge. Let's go.
Yeah, I'm glad you
and I'm glad I didn't jump off the bridge either because I would have just floated.
Shout out to not jumping off the bridge.
Don't jump off the bridge.
Shout out to not doing that.
It'd be my luck. I still live. Just a bunch of broken bones. And even more fucking pain. And be like, what the fuck was I thinking?
Right. Like, you go to jail for attempted murder?
Yeah, go to for attempted murder on yourself. On yourself.
Damn.
Being black, that's what would happen.
Absolutely.
Okay. That's exactly. They'd be like, we got to lock your ass up. Uh-huh.
But you was ready to do it.
I was ready. And then I went to therapy. And the therapist I went to probably wasn't the best therapist. And the first thing they wanted to do was prescribe me medication.
Okay.
And, you know, I was down for whatever at that point. I was like, shit, bring the pills. Whatever. Like, let's try it. Shit.
Right.
See what happens. And I took some Paxil, and then they put me on some Prozac, and all that. They kept changing it up because that shit was making me 21, and that shit was making me dry as fuck. I was like, this ain't working out for me, bruh. And then that's when I started smoking weed.
And that worked perfectly.
That worked perfectly.
Bring on the weed.
Damn. Shout out to weed.
And yeah. But while I was in therapy though, what I learned was that I needed to stop trying to be something that I wasn't. That's what I think what was messing me up is I was trying to be something that I was not. Okay. And it was really difficult for me to function because it's not comfortable, right?
Right, absolutely.
So, and I was pretending all the time and that was causing me a lot of distress. So once I stopped doing that, it was funny because the therapist was like, what makes you happy? What brings you joy? I was like hearing people laugh and laughing with them. Like that's the sound of ha 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 is like, that's like magic to me.
Yeah.
That raises my vibrations. They was like, well, why don't you get back into doing stand up as a hobby? So I got back into doing it as a hobby and it's just like everything shifted. And it's by my second show that I was getting paid.
Nice.
You know?
Damn.
So it was, and I love it. It brings me all the joy.
That's dope. Nice. That's dope as hell. I'm still trying to wrap my head around the fact that there are bad therapists.
There are. But you crazy. Think, aren't there bad rappers?
No, but I mean,
yeah.
Our job ain't to sit and listen.
I was about to say, you ain't got to say nothing as a therapist.
Yeah, it seems like you should have less bars as a therapist.
But there's a gang of men out here that can't listen.
I mean, yeah, but they're not getting degrees and shit and starting their own office and practicing.
Yeah, but there's even bad doctors. There's somebody bad at every profession. There's like, in every profession, there's somebody that sucks.
But I feel like that one should be the one they, like, it's hard to get into.
Some people don't even want you to, like, correct them or anything. They just want you to, like, listen the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Get their vent off.
So what if I let you get my vent off to me, right, and I fall asleep on you? Is that like a bad therapist?
Well, that was a bad therapist.
What if you if you've been doing therapy all day and you're just tired from?
Well, then you should reschedule my appointment.
Okay, you should probably reschedule my appointment. Probably needed the money though.
Yeah, because they're a bad therapist. They're probably
Oh shit! But look,
I mean,
here,
my therapist. I think they were bad because they would laugh at everything I had to say. They was laughing at me the whole time. I might be sitting there crying, telling the story, talking about something that's affecting me, and they started laughing in my face, which would piss me. I'd be like, what the fuck you laughing at?
But then
I kind of liked it too though.
Yeah, that's because you're just naturally funny. So it's kind of, I mean, I don't know,
and some people would beg to differ on that. Some people would say she's not funny at all, she's just annoying.
I mean, that's some people that
they say that about me all the time. So yeah. You think I give a fuck?
And those are the people
what?
I say.
What you gonna what?
Keep watching.
Watch.
Keep watching.
See.
That's I'm obviously are you affecting a Pisces? Your spirit. I'm a Sagittarius.
I don't know what that is.
I'm not a Sagittarius. I'm a Libra.
You a Libra?
I'm a Libra.
You a Pisces? Libra.
Yeah, see what I'm saying? Fuck y'all. No, I'm a Pisces. Fuck them.
Okay. We're the best.
Yeah. No, y'all wishy-washy than a motherfucker.
No, we not.
Yes, Charlie.
She's like a mix of every Zodiac put together.
Well, that's not true at all.
Nah, that is not true.
That's not true.
Y'all don't know what y'all really want. Y'all be like, on one second street. You want this, and you be like, I don't know, maybe I want that.
Well, absolutely. That's
it's a fish. It's like swimming, changing direction.
That do sound like me, though.
Yeah, y'all very sensitive, though. Great lovers.
Absolutely.
You love writing shit down. You always writing down numbers and words and stuff.
He's not doing that.
I ain't writing no numbers down.
I don't write no numbers down.
But you write words.
Y'all right.
He don't. He be trying to.
This nigga can't read, huh?
No. It's not looking good for him. Hey, look, I'll tell you what's better than therapy sometimes.
What?
Sex?
Drinks from Bam Bam! Tiffany, I don't know if you know, but my wife is a certified mixologist.
Hey!
Every single one of these episodes, she makes the guests their own drink.
Thank you.
This is a one-of-one recipe. This is your shit. You can take it home.
It's a Tiffany teeny. Is that an octopus at the bottom of there? What the fuck is this? Oh, it's a hibiscus.
Yes.
It's a dehydrated hibiscus.
But it's edible, and you can do whatever you want to it.
It's a Tiffany City.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Tiffany and Co.
No, we got to call it the Tiffany City.
It's called the Tiffany City now. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I came up with that. Thank you.
Nope. I patent that name. Actually, I own this drink now.
Too late.
Too late.
We made it up in the club.
They've been calling me Tiffnicity since 1999, nigga.
Since 19th Tiffnicity.
She don't stop. She don't quit. Tiffnicity is all up in his bitch. Popping that thing, getting me rich. What you wanna do? I'm a real rich chick. She ready.
Ready.
Tiffnicity keeping it steady. Drinking all my drink like Eddie. From Herman Monster, we plenty.
Oh, you petty.
I am petty.
Boys, I'm the queen of petty. Don't get it. That's too goddamn good. Guys, sip, drink. We'll be right back. It's Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. We will be. Hit that button for me.
Shut it down.
Right back. Yo, thanks for listening to the podcast. Make sure you subscribe so you can get the new episodes dropping every week. I want to take this time to tell you about one of our great sponsors, CBDX.com. It's time for you to step your game up to CBDX.com. CBDX.com sells Delta 8 products, which feels just like cannabis. Their gummies and vapes are made with Delta 8 THC, which is a new cannabinoid that's taken over the hemp health and wellness market. That means you'll have more stress-free, relaxing days to look forward to. Just go to CBDX.com and use my code TPain, and you'll get 20% off and get yourself some gummies or a vape. Remember, never drive or operate heavy machinery when you're using these products. Please be responsible. The days of paying high prices at the dispensary are over. Stay home, keep listening to this podcast, and let CBDX ship it right to your door. Just go to CBDX.com and use my code TPain for 20% off and get yourself some gummies or a vape. That's CBDX.com. Use code TPain and get yourself some gummies or a vape. You'll be blown away that this is even legal and shipped directly to you. Holla. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Tiffany Haddish and his motherfucking up. All right, Tiff, you ready? Because it's time for your top five.
You thought about this already?
Of course not. Why would I think? Oh. What, am I responsible?
Okay.
I don't do that. I don't think of shit beforehand. you got to chill with people. You got to sit. You got to make sure you're just there. Tip, I have not thought about this whatsoever. But from what you just said, now I want to know, and I'm curious, what are your top five favorite fast food chains?
Hot. Well, my top five.
She was talking about this a lot during the break. I'm sorry. This is time. Take your time. No particular order. Just do your thing. Make it easy.
Okay, so top five fast food chains that are my favorite. Mm-hmm. I love me some In-N-Out Burger, double animal style, extra pickle protein style.
Okay.
Yeah. with the peppers. I need the peppers.
They can put all that on a burger?
Yeah, I didn't know they even had that.
Oh, shit. There's all kind of stuff you can get at In-N-Out Burger, baby, that you don't know about. You have to be a avid customer to know these things. Yeah, I'm not one of those. Yep. I don't like the fries, though. Don't get me started on the fries.
Nobody they got fries. Nobody likes fries.
I'm like, I make fries from scratch, too. They never taste like that shit. They never taste like styrofoam.
Fries from scratch 4 days ago. Yeah.
No, you see them
they
cutting
look
potatoes.
Like
that,
but they only have to taste
they're cutting the potatoes for next week.
Yeah, you're right.
You can see it happen. You don't give a shit about you seeing it.
Okay. Also, let me some Popeye's chicken. I like Popeye's. Right, but I just like the green beans and the mashed potatoes and gravy.
Yeah.
And two chicken legs.
Is Popeye's fast food?
Yeah, jalapeno.
Is it fast?
Except
though?
When you're in a rush.
No. You be sitting in the driveway for 45 minutes, goddamn, because everybody wants some.
I don't know what's wrong with our Popeyes over here, but they never have chicken.
Bro.
They run out of the main thing that they sell. It's supply and demand. You got to have the one product that's in the name of your restaurant.
Well, that's why you get the green beans.
They sell shrimp, too. I don't know if y'all know, but the shrimp is good.
I ain't fucking with the shrimp.
Probably, what?
If they got chicken in their name, I'm not eating no seafood. Yeah,
butterfly shrimp is fire.
I'm already weary of sandwiches from that motherfucker.
People get stabbed over their sandwiches, and I don't know why. And the sandwiches ain't shit.
Yeah,
but anyway,
I still ain't had one.
KFC.
Don't
you
do
talking
it.
About KFC, not Popeyes.
Nobody goes to KFC.
Nobody goes.
They
to
the
KFC.
Ones that got the sandwich.
They're dead.
No, Popeyes.
You talking about the double down? The one that's made out of the two chicken breasts.
That's the best sandwich ever.
That was crazy.
Really?
That's the best sandwich. Two chicken fillet.
They selling like real chicken now.
No.
KFC does in certain places.
They selling what chicken?
They sell the fake chicken, like Believe chicken. Impossible.
Oh, okay. How about you?
See, we all eat meat, so we don't give a fuck about meat.
Okay, I was just saying, but nobody goes to KFC vegan? No more. No, I'm saying, but KFC started selling not chicken because nobody goes there anymore.
But they've been selling not chicken.
I don't think that's been chicken from the
been all that shit been.
Okay, so
Taco Bell.
Popeyes. Oh, Taco Bell.
Let's go.
Taco Bell.
When I was homeless, I used to eat Taco Bell every day, bean burrito with extra cheese.
That's not
two of them.
Oh,
but I was my body was banging.
Yeah, how did that work?
I was butt.
You had a fat butt?
I mean, little bubble butt. Okay. Little bubble booty. Yeah, I had abs.
What you
had abs because all I was eating was bean burrito. I had abs.
Yeah, how the fuck does that work?
I had abs. And I did have gas. And I was shitty bang bang. But it's something about a Taco Bell bean burrito.
This is fucked up.
What do you mean
eat Taco Bell and get better?
But I just who said I was better? I was already down bad, bruh. I didn't have a lot of money. That back then, this was the early 2000s, late 1900s, okay? So at that point in time, a bean burrito was like 59 cents.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah.
50 cents. Some days, mm-hmm. sometimes they would have a sale, it'd be 25 cents.
Did they have a crunch wrap back then?
No, they didn't have the crunch wrap. They didn't have a crunch wrap back then. No, some days it would be 25 cents, bruh.
I eat one burrito from that bitch. I gotta rethink my outfits for the week.
But that's now. I think they did something to the beans. And she's like, I haven't. I only eat it now on my period, or like if I'm really, wow. really need it. Like I'm like, I need to be humbled again. I need to remember what it feels like to not have shit, because I'm tripping. My brain is getting bigger than my body. Like I'm tripping, and then I'll eat a bean burrito and two tacos. Now you know what? Somebody, when your ego start to get a little bit out of control.
No.
No.
Yeah, no, I've had a lot of people tell me that. I just didn't believe it. I didn't.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Ego out of control. You mean, that's when you gotta eat a cup of noodles or something. Nigga gotta get humble.
I keep noodles.
Oh yeah, noodles is good.
I got a motherfucking palate of shrimp flavor in that motherfucker upstairs.
Man, nice. Really?
I keep it, yeah.
Do you put like vegetables in yours?
Nothing.
I just do packs in a big ass bowl.
Chicken, everything.
Yeah, I be putting squash in mine and broccoli and a little bit.
Okay, now that's faux now.
And that's not thinking that you not.
Yeah, that's faux. That's
you gonna put. But I did it when I was a kid. When I was a kid, I used to put hot dogs in there.
Nah, y'all used to put hot dogs in there. Y'all turning a 4-minute operation into a night.
It turns into a romantic dinner when I remember. Hey, you remember being broke and going on dates? I used to be like, I want to take you out, but I ain't got a lot of money. I'd be like, take me to the park, let's get a blanket, let's go to Taco Bell, get some burritos, and then go to the liquor store and get a fifth, you know. And we just sit in the park and then we drink and eat burritos and then fucking. Nah. Make out and go to sleep under the sun.
All my broke dates was like, hey, come with me while I sell this weed real quick. We can hold hands on the way there, but you gotta fucking be in the back seat when it happens.
I dated a dude like that too. I dated that dude.
I like the
broke picnics in the park. They make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, and then we just talk and look at each other, and she look around us.
The Lunchable charcuterie board.
The Lunchable charcuterie. What you know about that? Man, that's my shit.
I don't
even
know what that is.
I'm a real basic
Lunchables.
Chick.
You lay lunch. You just break up the Lunchables, lay it out on a little slab of wood, and now you got a charcuterie board.
Yeah. It's sexy.
A charcuterie board. It's one of them meat plates they be having at the shows and shit all the time.
You don't know what a charcuterie is?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
With the meat and cheese and shit.
The thing that we don't eat?
Yeah,
correct. Absolutely.
Okay, I know what that is.
Everybody been breathing all over
me. I only eat the almonds and the apricots off of there.
And all the college shows.
I can't eat nothing off of that. I know everybody been breathing
everybody
over
been breathing
shit.
Over that.
That's terrible.
Okay. What's this?
That's good for my immune system. I think to myself, it builds up my immune system. Mm. Let me tell you my other favorite.
What are we on, four?
Yeah.
So my other favorite fast food is, and I don't even know if it's fast food, but I love Waffle House.
Yeah, that's fast food. Step in. After the club, it's too many people.
I love Waffle House.
Yeah, you got to go there at the right time.
We don't have a Waffle House in Los Angeles. I'm from LA. We don't have that here. So the first time I came to the South, I was visiting my homegirl. She was going to Clark, and I came to visit her. She was like, "Girl, you got to try this new shit. It's called Waffle House. It's new shit."
It was new to us.
Excited
about that?
I was like, "Oh my god, okay, I'm gonna come." So I came. I came to Georgia, and at the time I was working for an airline. So we was, I had stayed for like a month. I had got all this time off work, and I stayed for like a month. So
God
I was going
damn.
To class with her and everything.
Shit.
And we was going to Waffle House like every other day, and I fell in love. And then we start going to different Waffle Houses and stuff, and I started realizing, I said, girl, the best cooks are the ones that's missing teeth. Whoever teeth is the raggediest. They make the best hash browns smothered and diced. You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
karate chopped, all that shit.
Karate chopped.
So when did the heart problem start? Because that's inevitable after eating Waffle House every motherfucking day.
I ain't had no heart problems. I mean, well, broken hearts.
What's going on with your body? How do you eat the worst shit and still come out?
First of all,
breathing normal and shit.
First of all, I exercise.
Mm-mm.
It's called dancing.
Mm-hmm.
Every day I dance. Mm-hmm. I'm a dancing machine.
Okay.
Second of all, I didn't eat that shit every day. Like, just on my period. And we talking about the 1900s, nigga. This was 1998.
That's true.
So this was, okay. My immune system was impeccable.
I don't know. 98 Waffle House was goddamn Wild West. They didn't have no rules in that
bitch. I know. That shit was fun as fuck. It was so much fun.
Goddamn cookies and nuts, smoking cigarettes and shit. They ain't give a fuck about that. None of
that shit. How do they remember in every Waffle House... They remember everything that everybody's saying. Don't
and
write
that
shit down. Down.
Goddamn nothing down. They don't motherfuckers write shit. Got the best memory. I think all the motherfuckers was mailmen at some point.
Nah. They was all number runners. They was all number runners.
Yeah, that's true. That makes sense.
In the 1900s.
In the 1900s, they was running numbers. They want the sun side, the sunny side, of the rich side, the secretash, and then the dash dash, and the nudders, and the well done. Kick it.
And the motherfuckers. Don't even respond.
Don't
they,
say no, nothing.
Don't even respond. They just keep cooking.
Nothing at all.
And they be standing on the dot. They train though. Look, they train them. So I was thinking about, and I'm gonna reach out to Waffle House. I would like, cause you know they got their own farms. I'm into that.
They got their own farms.
I actually eggs.
I didn't know that.
Where they get them steaks from? Cause them shit's flat as a fool.
Man, cause this how they slice them. They slice them right. Then they smash them down.
Okay.
It's how you slice the meat, baby. But yeah, they got their own little farms and stuff. And so I was thinking about reaching out to them because the Waffle House that's closest to the West Coast is in Phoenix, Arizona. Mm. And I was thinking, man, if we opened up a Waffle House in Hollywood, I'm gonna be fat. I don't give a
fuck. Hollywood gonna fuck it up though.
They gonna fuck it up.
Nah, how you think they gonna fuck it up?
Hollywood gonna fuck it up. They gonna have all the vegan options.
No, we ain't doing that. We ain't doing that.
They gonna change this shit to grass fed. People don't want that real shit.
Nah. We ain't doing that. It's Waffle House.
Yeah. Until LA get a hold of it.
I'm telling you, I promise you, this gonna be my Waffle House. I'm gonna have cooks with no teeth and all this shit. It's gonna be fire.
I'm telling you, give it 2 months. They're gonna have fucking Waffle House wheatgrass smoothie and shit.
No, we ain't. We gonna have the same thing they got at every Waffle House the same. They train. They got Waffle House School, Waffle House University.
I don't think so.
And that's what they teach them. Is what we go to.
They teach them.
Not in motherfucking LA. It's gonna be the goddamn same people that make all the goddamn catering tables for the goddamn sets and shit.
They gonna have all suits on and shit. All clean and nice.
I'm gonna get this nigga's cousin to come through because I know his cousin work at Waffle House. Get his cousin to come manage it. We gonna hire 17 people that got fired from the Waffle House out here to come on to LA. I'm putting them in one of my apartment buildings right next door.
All right, what's the last one? What's your last favorite fast food place? Franchise. Should have made that all F's. Yeah, favorite fast food franchise.
It has to be a franchise.
No. Absolutely.
Okay, because at this one, LAX Tacos.
Really?
LAX Tacos is my absolute favorite. Mm. LAX Tacos. I made the theme song.
They got a song.
Them.
Okay.
They don't have one. But I just took the Nick's Check Cashin' song and made it for LAX Tacos.
Oh, wow.
LAX Tacos, you're somebody special.
That's not fair.
Damn.
Get sued from somebody.
Hire her quick.
Just get it now. Get it now while the price is up.
I love LAX Tacos. Whenever I fly into LA, I go straight to LAX Tacos. Get me 5 to 6 carne asada tacos with cheese, no onions, but with cilantro and salsa, and then some lemonade. And that takes me like a day and a half to eat all the tacos.
Oh. No onions.
No onions.
But then cilantro.
Cilantro, yes. That's like lettuce, but it's good. It removes heavy metals from your body.
It's not like lettuce.
Yeah, it removes heavy metals from your body. Cilantro is very good for you.
But it's not like lettuce.
No, it's not. It has a different tangy taste to it. That's for sure. It got a flavor. Unlike lettuce. But it's green like lettuce. It's green like romaine.
You would have had everybody
with green.
That.
It's green like romaine.
And he don't eat green shit, so he don't fuck.
I could tell. I could tell he don't eat green shit. That's why he got the dark spots. I could tell.
How does everybody know?
You get that. When you start eating greens, your shit gonna be beautiful, my man. Like, you already got okay skin, but it's gonna be glorious when you start eating greens.
You still here?
Yep. Yeah, that's how Charlamagne the God's face changed. You know, he started eating greens.
Is that? Not what happens. That man started getting facials every day.
And then he started getting facials, but he also started eating more greens. I mean, skin is, you know, it starts from the inside. Then it come out.
to inner layers.
Is that like her last one? We going on or what?
No,
I'm keep on fucking with you.
Absolutely, I'm all here. I'm here.
I think we on. That was the last one.
That was the last one. But I would love to
hit the button.
No.
Oh, you know what else place I love though? I love.
Honorable mention coming in. Here we go. Honorable mention.
Mel's Fish Shack on Jefferson in Farmdale in Los Angeles. On Mondays they have crab soup, the most delicious fucking crab soup you ever had in your whole mother. Life. And then they fry up that red snapper because I always order it. Yep. And I fry it. And then they fry up the shrimp. I order that too. It's so motherfucking delicious. And then you get that shit with the collard greens. And then you get it with the red beans and rice.
Yep.
It's so good. And that's when I get the fucking.
Shouts out to the snapper. And the place that we're going to tonight.
Mel's Fish Shack. It's in LA though. It's in LA.
No, we can get it Uber Eats.
Yeah, we can get it.
We gonna get that. I have unlimited Uber Eats.
We gonna get that.
Oh shit. Well, that was that was a motherfucking top five right there. It was very descriptive.
Yeah, well, I love food.
I can see.
You know, I'm gonna open up a grocery store just so I can sell food. And I can have unlimited food.
Is you gonna take food?
I don't think that's how grocery stores work. Right.
Yeah. That is how grocery stores work.
You just, the owner just gonna have unlimited food?
The owner gets to have whatever the fuck they want. They own the goddamn store.
I mean, if you pay for it, you gotta.
No, I own it. I bought the shit.
You gotta have unlimited money for unlimited food. You can't just
like
have regular
food.
If you eating all the damn food, where the money gonna come from?
First of all, I can't eat all the food, okay? And
from what you've told us today, I got a strong belief that you
can eat all the food.
You still be the same shape?
I can taste all the food.
You just have a bite of everything?
I can taste it.
I'm just having a little bite of everything.
I can taste it. It's a grocery store, though. So
you do that when you get your food at a restaurant? When they bring your food at a restaurant, you do this?
No, I don't do that. No. When they bring my food at the restaurant, I'll be like, ee!
That's a version of it. That's a version of it. You're just less quiet about it. But that was Tiffany's Top 5, guys. Shit. Go put your... Put your own favorite places that she didn't say, because everybody on the internet always has a better top five than our guests, apparently.
Well, yeah, because everyone has a different palate. But fuck your palate. Yeah, my palate's the best.
Good news is we only asked her, so figure that shit out.
Ask PJ.
you got?
Yeah, I got top five.
Oh, she was ready.
She ready.
Come on, Peach.
Okay. Wendy's.
Mm-hmm. Oh wow!
Because that was the first one that had a dollar cheeseburger.
That helps. That helps bacon a lot. That does help a lot.
Nah, McDonald's was the first, but that was 1958.
They never had a bacon cheeseburger for a dollar.
Yes, they did. Yes, they did in 1987. You can get.
I wasn't there. I didn't see it.
I'm from the 1900s. Okay, that's okay. Go ahead. Whatever.
I wasn't
Wendy's.
There yet.
Oh, you wasn't.
Popeyes. No, I got Popeyes.
You can't say you.
I can't say her. I can't.
You
say
can't. It's like Family Feud. You gotta say it different.
Do you want this car or not?
I like Burger King. I haven't been there in a long
time. Oh, Burger King!
But I always thought their fries was fire. Like
they do have fire fries. They do have fire fries for sure.
Who got fried okra? Oh, Church's back in the day.
Hey, Church's still got that fried okra. Yeah. I just got some the other day.
Fried okra is fire to me. Green. I love fried okra.
But their fried okra is nothing like my fried okra. My okra is better. You should try.
I don't like okra at all.
Well, you ain't tried
it's
mine.
Good for you. It's good for your digestion.
Slimy. It's the texture.
It's good for your digestion.
And it gets rid of diabetes.
I bet it is, because it's fucking slimy. Slime up and just
and get out.
Coats up your intestines.
But it's really good for diabetes. It gets rid of diabetes, yo.
Really?
Yep.
You ain't going to eat that shit either.
No, you don't got to eat it. What you can do is you can cut it up, right? And then you get a gallon of water. You put like half a pound of cut up okra in the water. Put
half
it in
a pound.
What did I say? Half a pound. Okay. Listen to the motherfucking recipe. Dr. Haddish is talking right now. Okay.
Okay.
Shut the fuck up while I give the recipe. Now. All right. You get a half a pound of okra. You get a gallon of water. You cut the half a pound and cut that up. Put that in the water. Put that in the refrigerator overnight, up to 7 to 8 hours. Take that out. You drink. It's a little slimy.
Ew.
But you swallow some shit before. You know how much you. It's just like that.
It's different. It's not the same consistency.
Just act like it's coochie right there and just swallow it.
It's not the same consistency.
Same shit, nigga. Same shit. And get your whole blood sugar right. Get rid of the diabetes.
Off that one time?
No, you gotta drink the whole goddamn gallon.
No, I'm saying, if you drink the whole thing that one time.
The day, probably once or twice a week. You know what I'm saying?
But forever.
How thick is it though? Like,
It ain't that thick. It's a little slimy though.
I gotta look this shit up.
That's look at that. Google
it. Google.
I can't do it.
Google it. Yep.
Oh, nobody Jesus. Said White Castle, huh?
No.
Shut up.
They got a this movie.
The best restaurant of
Diarrhea
all time.
Factory.
And if you want to cleanse and eat that.
Christmas
got if you want to cleanse. We're going to figure it out. That was the top 10 fast food favorite, top five fast
franchise.
The FFF.
Right.
Favorite fast food.
Figure it out. It's Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. We will be.
Shut it down.
Right back.
Down,
you're going to kill the button.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm very heavy-handed. I'll do it like this next time.
Shut it down.
Perfect. See?
Shut
we'll be right
down.
Yep.
Shut see? It. Shut it.
Not a bad idea.
Shut it. Shut it. Shut it. Shut it. Shut it. Shut it down. Shut it down. Shut it, down. Mm-hmm.
It don't really do a
it
remix.
It don't do shut,
nah.
Shut, shut it down.
Nah, that's right, how I was hoping it would.
You got to yeah, like give that. It time. You worry about all the chemicals you keep putting in your yard, trying to make it look its best? Traditional lawn care lay down about 90 million pounds of pesticide each year. Sunday is different. Now you don't have to choose between having a beautiful yard and keeping your family out of harm's way. Sunday can help you grow a beautiful lawn without the guesswork or the nasty chemicals. Their custom plan includes fertilizer and everything you need to easily care for your lawn with ingredients like seaweed and iron and molasses. You can feel good with the kids and the pets being around all of it. All you have to do is visit GetSunday.com, put in your address, and their lawn analysis tool does the rest. They then use soil and climate data to create a personal nutrient plan delivered right to your door when you need it. Growing a healthy lawn doesn't have to be super hard. Just attach the ready-to-use pouch to a garden hose and spray it up. Takes less than 15 minutes. Best of all, the stuff really works. Right now, Sunday is offering my listeners 20% off. Full season plan starts at just $129. And you get 20% off at checkout when you visit GetSunday.com/TPain. That's 20% off your custom plan at GetSunday.com/TPain.
On today's episode of How Fucked Up Is Fucked Up. That's fucked up.
Tiff.
Yeah.
What's fucked up?
Oh, God, there's so many things that's fucked up.
Yeah, that's a lot.
It's so many things.
What's your
I try not to focus on what's fucked up. I try to focus on what's not fucked up.
What's right?
The good thing is, you ain't got to worry about that right now. Tiff, what's your favorite fucked up thing? You know what my favorite fucked up thing is?
What?
People are barbers when they comb your shit weird. When they don't rake it, when they don't like, when barbers comb my beard, they don't rake it like I do. They try to put it flat up against my shit, and then they go through like that. So it's kind of combing it like four times, like at the same time.
Oh.
That's my favorite fucked up thing, because that shit hurts.
Nice.
And I really don't want them to do that no more. I stopped going to barbers and start cutting my own shit, which is why this is all fucked up.
you had that same excuse like five episodes ago. What the fuck, man?
I'm still trying. I got to keep letting it grow back so I can just fucking figure it out.
So you got to fuck it up again.
You got to practice.
It's not a quick process. You got
to need to watch more YouTube
videos.
I got
a different comb. I got a black.
But is there like a special? Isn't that
it's a beard comb now. Niggas be using them the little joints with the stick on the end of it.
The rat tooth?
Rat tail.
Don't use that on my beard, bro. You know what I'm saying? That's not a beard comb, bro. The same.
So what's a beard comb?
A beard comb has got thick motherfucking teeth on it, and it's got the two sides, one with that side and one with this side. You know what I'm saying?
Nah.
It's got this side and this side.
That's a detangler comb.
That's what we call a detangler comb.
Okay, maybe I'm thinking like
y'all just
this
got
side.
That. Y'all just
no,
got
I
that.
Know we exactly what you're talking about.
You know what I'm saying? But it's a thicker thing. Some of them made out of wood. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like it's a different. Don't comb my beard with the same shit you just combed that nigga Caesar with before me. I saw you do it. You ain't do no barberside, nothing. I saw that shit, bro.
I be telling him to do that to my beard too.
You know, yo,
what
no
now?
Damn beard.
Yo, what now?
My beard.
Yo, who? Yo,
my beard.
When does that happen?
My beard. I cut it.
Alternate universe.
You know that is velcroed onto your fucking lip, nigga. I've been looking at that shit all night, and I'm like, I know that shit finna melt off. If he get too hot, that's it. He got double stick tape on some coochie hairs.
That's why it's so cold in here.
You got coochie hairs.
Oh, man.
You so handsome.
You like it, though, don't you?
I do. You look like a pirate. I like that shit. Come and get this booty, nigga. Come and get this booty. Arr, matey.
Oh, shit.
You know, the original Pirates was black anyway, so.
Yeah, yeah.
My dad was a pirate. I'm
proud of that. Tiff, what's fucked up?
Well, since we talking about that, like, what's fucked up is...
Pirates?
No, no. We talking about hair. You talking about hair. So, okay. What's fucked up on me right now is my... this part of my hair right here. I don't know what the fuck's going on.
I'll tell you what. Hey, let me
it's
tell you something.
Right here.
Hey, look.
You know, I know he got them clippers in, hey, look, in his barbershop back there.
That's what I'm telling you. I know I don't look the part right now, but yeah. I can hook you up. I'm telling you.
Nah. I wouldn't let you do it.
I'm
actually letting it grow back right now. But the thing, you know what used to be so fucked up for me was when I would get my hair done and do ponytails. I used to hate it because my beautician, she had big titties and she always put her titties on my fucking neck. And like pull my head into her goddamn titties.
What shop she work
and
at?
I fucking hate that shit.
That's crazy.
I hate that. I don't like my head on people's titties.
Why you cut your hair?
Because I wanted to see my scalp and I was tired of titties on the back of my fucking neck. Tired of these bitches pulling at my scalp, making my thoughts ooze out of my edges.
They do be braiding tight. They do be braiding too tight.
Braiding too goddamn
tight. Too tight.
Putting their titties on your fucking shoulders and shit. Get your titties off my shoulders, bitch. I pay too much money. Then I start going to men to get my hair done. Then they balls is like on my damn elbow. I like it. I like it. No shade. I don't mind it. But I had a man at the time. It was very inconvenient. So wait, I was like, let me just cut it off.
Nice.
And you just can't win. So you just chill.
I wanted to see my scalp too. I never seen it. You know,
now you just wake up and go. Was that the reason though? Really?
Yeah, that was a real reason. I wanted to see my scalp. I never seen it before. Like I look at men. Like what I do is very male dominated, right? Mm-hmm, so mm-hmm. I watch how men move and I'm trying to figure out how do I move like a man but still be a woman, mm-hmm. right? I don't want to be a man, but I want to be as successful as a man. I really want to get paid like a man with a pink dick. You know what I'm saying? Like
pink
I
want to.
Yeah, I want to get paid like a man with a pink
dick. That's a different bracket.
That's that. You know what I'm saying? I want to get paid like I'm a man with a pink dick from Australia.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, I want to get talking about owning islands and shit.
That part.
Yeah.
That's how I watch how they move. Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
It's different.
Every night that I see they cut their hair all off, they grow it back, they do all this today.
Right.
You know, they can move like that. And when I finally did it, I was like incomplete. Like awe and amazement because I had never felt nothing like that in my whole life. Like your scalp is so sensitive.
Yeah.
And like to have the sun on it and you can feel it through your whole body. When it rains and it's touching your scalp, you can feel it through your whole body. It's like
just being
a million
like
kisses. Sun. Hey man, when I first cut it off, I was in Mississippi. and it was summer rain. First of all.
Oh, hot rain.
That hot rain, yeah. Which is, I'm from California. When it rains, it's cold. It don't rain hot, right? So
it rains there?
In California,
all the
yes,
time
it does.
The last 2 or 3 years, it's like it global, 40 days, 49.
Global warming is the real thing. And I never experienced thunder or lightning until I shot my first movie in New Orleans, and I was scared as fuck. I never experienced lightning and felt thunder like that ever until like I was like 27. But yeah, because I'm from California.
We're not glossing over that.
We're gonna come back to it. But when I was in Mississippi, when I cut my hair off, I went outside. And it started to rain. And I felt like God was kissing me all over my head. Like a billion kisses from God. And I could feel it all through every single organ in my body. All the way to my feet. Back up. I busted a nut in nature, nigga.
That's the...
And I came back in the house. I said, I'm so jealous of men. Men, all these years. All these motherfucking years. I never felt this. I'm 40 years old. I never fucking felt none of this before.
Damn.
Look at God. This is why niggas want to keep your head covered, because they don't want you to feel the glory of the Lord. They don't want you to feel the glory of the Lord, bro.
They're trying to keep you away from God.
I'm just saying, you ain't lived. Oh. Now, some women be talking, oh, I can't do that. You can do it. You got a head for it, bitch. Do it one time. You wear wigs anyways, ho. Nobody know what your real hair look like anyways. Ain't nobody see your real shit.
Okay, so after you got it cut, were you just been like this the whole time?
No, I cut it for like 6-7 months. I was just cutting it bald. I was in a relationship. He would cut it for me.
You went all the way down.
All the way down to the skin.
He was getting parts and shit.
Yeah, to the skin.
You gotta get him MC Hammer parts.
I got the part like twice, and I was like, I like combing it and making my own parts, like combing it. And
oh,
making
okay.
Part. But I'm letting it grow now. I'm gonna get some.
You got good hair though. That's the problem. That's
I got what hair?
You got good hair.
I do. This is better 4C. Than.
Oh, you should. You should
this shit nappy.
It's all good hair. It's all good hair.
Okay.
My head is fully covered, so that's good.
You have more functional hair.
Yeah, it's no.
Let me tell you something. If you can use
it, ain't functioning on this side.
That part. If you can use something and make a part and it stay there, that's functioning hair.
First of all, it don't stay.
Okay.
It don't
stay. I have to like discipline. I have to train it. Fucking brush it. Put a pencil there. Then put the fucking paper, the black paper around that bitch.
The black paper. I hate that fucking paper.
I love it. That motherfucker do wonders to my shit.
I hate that shit.
Super nice.
Yeah. Put that shit on my head.
I be trying to have baby hairs. Hey, my look, when I be on set and they be like, okay, we gonna lay your baby hairs out. And they be mad as fuck. Like, stop sweating, bitch. The baby hairs is turning into curls.
I can't deal with that shit. Anytime I get my hair done, my girl would put that black shit, the black paper in my head. That shit be on my legs by the time I wake up in the morning. How the fuck that shit be moving?
That shit be having can't me fucking like keep good. That shit on.
And have you ever tried to tie the black paper yourself?
Oh, it never works.
Oh, it never works. You're like, damn it. Well, how did I get this around my fucking head?
And it never the same. Breaking every time.
It break every time. Jesus Christ.
I'm like, okay, I'm going to be real gentle this time. And then it would just fall down over your eyes. You're like, what the fuck?
Damn professionals.
They don't be professional. They can see it. We can't fucking
see it. Yeah, they're above your head.
Right.
You try to do it like.
You right.
They got full view of the shit. Right. We just can't fucking see it. I've never to do the shit blind.
Middle of my
every dumb ass. Time I sit on the side. I don't right. Like the side on the side. Put yep. A little bow. Make it look cute.
Don't none of our dumb ass go in the mirror and try to do this shit. We just sit there just in the space. Just, God damn it. Well, that ain't it. All right. Which one is this?
This don't feel right.
We could easily fix this shit just go in the mirror. Nope. Doing the shit in the bed. Laying down.
Even when
down,
I'm man. In the mirror, it don't work. Wait. You put the paper on while you in the bed?
I have to. Because it come off. If I get, because I get my hair done. I get my hair done down here.
Okay.
So they put my head. By the time I fucking go upstairs, make some food, and fucking sit down, that shit just in a little
stack. It rolled out of my
right.
You got receding paper.
I can't deal with that shit, man. I just take that shit off and the shit be
they
all
don't
fucked up.
They don't put a do-rag on you.
That don't stay on my head.
That nigga do not wear do-rag.
Bro, I'm a real fucked up sleeper. It just don't have
you
every
sleeper too.
Everything I put on my head is on the other side of the room. At the end of the night.
You know why? Because while you sleep, you like get this shit.
I can't do nothing. Because
your body is in control of the body. You need to meditate.
No,
bro.
Because I got some pillows that when you put one pillow, it's not enough, but two pillows is too much. So I try to fold one pillow in half.
Oh.
But I be doing it with my head sometimes, and I try to. Try to fluff up one side of the pillow.
Looking like a pound puppy.
like a goddamn rhinoceros in that motherfucker trying to.
You ever see dogs do that? Dogs be like.
Trying to fix my shit with my face because I want to move the rest of my fucking body. That's it. So, you know, that shit don't ever stay on my goddamn head.
You
got
a double wrap to do it. They got these new, like, head tie, hair wraps. Like,
see, but you know what I don't like? I don't like marks on my forehead anymore.
You can't tie it too tight. It's an art.
It's an art. Now, there's this one that's out right now.
It's an art.
I'm going to send you something because they got this one with the elastic. This elastic.
Elastic band.
Let me tell you something.
A lock stop. Have you tried a lock stop?
I got so many.
Oh, damn.
So
oh, my God. You got a whole
sleeper.
Drawer full of bonnets. Full of bonnets and skull caps.
I got so much shit
like,
because every time
like, look at this shit.
Every time I explain this fucking problem, some girl tell me, oh, no, I got the thing that's going to help.
You
that
just
got
to, like,
and that bitch be
it's
cross
the same
down.
Shit from China, motherfucker. You don't see me no more of this shit.
I will say this. One your homegirl gave me that one, and she got the adjustable shit where you can pull it. It don't stay on.
But good try, though. Good try.
I just wanted to highlight that one. That was it.
It was close.
It was a good try. But, yeah, that's what's fucked up.
Yeah.
God damn.
You know what else is fucked up?
What else is fucked up?
It's dry out here. It's just dry out here.
It's dry out here, not L.A.?
It's dry out here.
She talking about something
you're
else.
Talking about niggas.
You got to be talking about the
you
niggas.
You talking about niggas.
Yeah.
I concur.
You dry out here. That shit fucked up. Hey, when a nigga tell you he want to be your Amber Rose, When I tell you the pussy dried up so fast. Nigga said he wanna be my Amber Rose. I said, wait.
Wait!
I can't wait to get back to LA.
Holy shit.
So what
shit.
Would that mean, actually? What
wait, a nigga said he wanna be your Amber Rose?
Yes.
Okay, I'm not fucking.
He wanna that. Be on the carpet with me and shit. He wanna do He wanna do the, I guess he wanna do the tramp walk.
Wait, even walk. Oh. I was about to say, wait, even Amber Rose got her own shit going on, nigga. God damn. He just don't want nothing.
But this Amber nigga. Rose, and she got her way up there, right?
I want to be a stay-at-home dad.
But I like that. Now, if a nigga said, that to me.
Really? That's your jam?
That's my jam.
That's it?
I want to be a stay-at-home dad. I want to take care of your dogs. I want to take care of your house dogs. Clean. I make sure your clothes is washed. Sure clothes when you get home. When you get home, baby. When you get home, I'm gonna be here to listen to you.
When you get home, I'm gonna be here to
listen
to you.
Food gonna be ready.
The food is gonna be ready.
Niggas
gonna have a bed made for you. I'm gonna tuck that ass in.
Matter
of fact, I'm gonna have a bubble bath going for you.
Matter of fact, I'm gonna have a bubble bath for you.
Are you ready?
Whoa!
You wanna be a house bath, man?
Y'all heard that? No.
Oh, okay.
All right, you get that nigga in there. You think he's gonna say all that shit, you get home the first day. Babe, these dogs been shitting everywhere. I don't know what's going on. Babe, you gotta come home right now. You gotta get your off the set. Babe, the dog shitted in the kitchen and the Roomba started and it went all around the house. I don't know what's going on. Something's happening in here. Babe, how you work the coffee, man? God, it just started. Ain't no cup in there, nothing.
But I want that. Like, he called me throughout the day. How do you turn the dishwasher on?
But you want to know how to do it, though. He should know how to do it.
You want a dumbass nigga then.
I just want him to check in with me to let me know he doing things around the house. Like, I don't have no swimming pool right now, but if I got a pool, I would want him to know how to clean the pool. I would want him to know how to, like,
wash. This sounds like a full day.
You want a handyman.
You want a
handyman.
Yes. I want him doing shit around.
It sounds like to me you want multiple niggas. This ain't one nigga.
No, like a nigga.
This ain't one nigga's worth of work.
That's a good idea.
You need a compound. You start a cult.
You going to jail.
You know what I used to think?
You going to jail.
You need to start a cult.
No,
goddammit.
I ain't going to jail.
No, go
to
jail. Have no, I'm not. Skills.
They gonna tell on you.
Yeah,
but you see, I wanted that. I strive for that. But niggas, they so jealous of each other.
Whoa!
Like, how do you?
No,
how
not.
Do you have a compound?
That's not. Nah, I would be.
That's y'all.
It's no. Like
yeah,
I can't fuck all of them.
That's me. If I
yes, you
like,
can.
If no, I
was,
I can't. Yeah,
if I was in a situation, I definitely want to.
Because you gotta have a top nigga and like scrub.
They gonna try to fight each other and shit.
Yeah, I definitely want to be top. For sure.
No. Unless you but, like make it plain who the scrub niggas are and who the top niggas are.
Right,
you can't do that.
Like, you gotta make the hierarchy.
But the scrub nigga gonna try to take the top nigga.
You can't make a hierarchy.
Now, when you do that,
you gonna fuck up the morale of the house.
That's how you mess it up. That's how you
gonna fuck up the morale of the house. You gotta make everybody feel like this.
My gay homeboy, like, he got that shit going on, and he said, you just pay these hoes and you let them know they hoes.
That's mostly, yeah. That's
can that, we get a clap?
You,
clap
for that. You pay these hoes and you let them know they hoes. I said, but these are men. These are men. These are not women. These are men. Mm-hmm. Like, they're men. He's like, no, they're hoes.
Same thing.
Treat them like hoes.
Absolutely.
And tell them, you go in there and you fucking pull the weeds out the goddamn garden.
I don't know about that now.
That's crazy. I just told your friend I was a hoe.
Oh, you a hoe?
I'm a hoe.
Well, look here.
I mean, I be trying to be a hoe.
Are you a top hoe or a bottom hoe?
I'm a top hoe. I'm definitely a top hoe.
You a top hoe?
Yeah, I'm a top
hoe. But you in your feelings, though.
Yeah.
You a sensitive hoe.
Top hoes don't get that feelings.
Absolutely.
Because he a Pisces.
That's why he's a Pisces.
So he not really good at being a hoe.
You also can't be a self-proclaimed top hoe.
That ain't for you to decide.
You gotta fight it out with the bottom hoe niggas and you gotta win.
No, if you the top hoe, that just means you the highest earning hoe. Like, you do the most fucking work. You wanna be the bottom hoe. You want to be the one that's holding it down. You better, you want to be the one that motivates the other hoes to go do what they got to do. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You assistant pimping. You assistant mistressing. You see, like I would be the mistress.
You're the house mom.
What's a male mistress?
Damn. You're the house mom.
The den father.
Facts.
I don't know what the fuck I be doing leaving myself into these conversations.
But you know what?
I don't know what the fuck be going on.
I have no idea where any of this came from.
Can I ask you a question?
Please, no.
Yeah, let me ask you a question.
Yes.
What do you want to be? Like, what's the goal? Like, what, do you want to be like, do you want to be an actor?
You know what?
I'm a musician, a comedian. Like, what do you want to be?
Hey, I want to, just real quick, before you keep going. Finish this all the way because I want to know too.
Okay.
This is we all in
what
this room.
You,
everybody in this room
want
to know.
Want to be.
Wow. That's.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is turning into a Pip episode.
Here we go with the confused.
No, God damn it.
I thought he said top hoe.
Confused ass Pisces.
Here we go.
What do you want to be?
The button don't work for you.
I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna be honest. This is maybe the first time being honest because that was some fuck shit that you just did right there.
You said you want to be the house husband.
I think me as myself, I think I'm still trying to figure that shit out.
How old are you?
I'm old enough.
How old is old enough?
I have not figured this shit out yet.
What brings you joy?
I like making people laugh. I like people
you like
around
it?
Me
what
smiling
brings
and laughing.
You joy?
That's what brings me joy. I like making people laugh around me. I like doing shit for other people. I like making other people like uplift them. I like if I'm given an idea, I'm like, oh, yeah, we should do this. And then everybody's like, ah, man. But then they kind of like, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, so you want to be a muse?
For uncut times.
You want to be the muse. You want to be the inspiration.
Yes.
For uncut times. You want to be the... Maybe you're the minister of inspiration. Mm. That's what you want to be?
Okay.
I like how you said that.
Not a lot of money in that, but go ahead.
But as long as the people around, I guess, I mean.
So let me ask you, how many kids do you have?
Damn.
Damn.
You going to do me like that?
No, I ain't did you yet.
I got one.
You got one?
Yep.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
You don't fucking know.
You don't know. How old are they?
Why are you doing me like this right now? They don't know.
This is great. Like, you know what? You know why? Because this needed to happen. We just needed the right person to do it.
How old are they? Do you know?
She's 3 weeks.
She's 3 weeks.
Yeah. Congrats.
And how old are you?
38.
Yeah. That's great. Okay, so are you with the mom?
What the fuck is this?
This is great.
This is fantastic. The good news is, she ain't fucking with you. Now this could be a whole roasting session, and this could be going the other way. This is good.
It's complicated.
It's complicated.
Yeah.
Why did you cheat on her?
No.
No.
No, we just haven't.
You homeless?
We have no. I'm that half a rent nigga. I'm the one of them niggas that pay half the rent.
Do you want to live rent free?
What does that mean technically?
I'm asking.
Like somebody else paid my bills, but I
like,
work for it.
Not that you paying a mortgage, but just that you have a roof over your head, but you don't have to pay
for the roof. No, I pay for the roof.
Oh, you want to pay for the roof?
Yeah, I pay for the roof.
Okay. You just want to.
Yeah, I want to pay for the roof. I want to live nice.
You want to live nice.
I know, I like to live nice.
You like to live nice.
Yeah.
But what if there was an opportunity for you to live nice and you don't have to pay the rent or the mortgage?
I'm probably going to take that, but that also sounds like Section 8.
Nope.
Sound like you're
so good. Look here. Let me tell you my dream.
Let me tell you, baby. Look at baby.
Look here, baby.
Look at baby. I can give you a
better life. I feel like you're right in the pocket of what I need for me.
Damn.
Now you said you like to be inspirational.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I need an inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, I could provide you housing.
Mm-hmm.
you could bring your baby mama and your 3-week-old baby with you. Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Every time I come home, I want you to use your artistic skills and inspire me. Okay. By being a different person from Black History. Every time I come home. So you're going to have to act.
Okay. Yeah.
I don't want to fuck you. I just want to have conversation.
I don't know now. This nigga got a fire
Who he
got
to be first?
This nigga got a fire ass Frederick Douglass. I don't know. I'm just saying you might want to.
That's what I'm talking about. I'm on some Booker T. Washington. I'm on some Frederick Douglass. I'm on some Cletus Randall. Nobody even know Cletus Randall.
You know what I'm saying? I can't tell.
Ain't nobody know him. But you got to figure out about him. Like, I want you to do your research. And when I come home.
Do he got to dress like him?
Dress like
Absolutely.
Him.
Absolutely.
He is that person. When I walk into my house, this nigga is Harriet Tubman. You feel me?
Oh, man.
And he tell me about what happened through his whole day, how it went down, you know what I'm saying? What happened in his day, oh, how he discovered the TV, all that shit.
You know what I'm saying? He discovered the TV. Okay, I feel it. That's kind of like a book report, though.
But you
a verbal book report.
Yeah. In a big
a
ass house.
Book report, okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Ain't no pool, though.
Ain't no pool.
Dang.
But
it's a bathtub. But,
got a jacuzzi tub. But you
boom,
keep, you keep inspiring me. I buy a bigger house that do got a pool.
Boom,
and you can clean it, and you can be the black. You do some history shit of the very first black pool boy.
Absolutely,
yeah.
There it is. Goddamn,
I got a job.
Yeah, that was good
enough for me. Goddamn it, you did a lot right there.
That was good. That's how you get them.
And what do you say? Do you accept the terms?
You don't even have to fuck. I don't want to fuck you no ways. I just want to be inspired.
This sounds easy like Sunday morning. I don't know if I would accept this like right
off. You accept the terms, yes or no?
You don't send me the pictures of the house?
Actually, I just bought two houses right next door to each other.
Oh!
Let me call her right now.
I'm going to time to have sex.
Oh, shit! God damn, oh ladies and gentlemen, somehow all of that is what's fucked up. We will be right back and we'll see if Pip took that offer. It's Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. We will be
shut it down
right back. What's holding you back from your ultimate gaming experience? Is it hundreds of dollars that it'll cost you to set it up, or you just super busy? You're on the go type of person with, you know, minutes to spare. I know that's how I am most of the time, but, you know, I'm also me, so there's that. Level up your game with Backbone, the universal gaming essentials that lets you instantly play hundreds of console games on your phone. No console required. Backbone is the newest game-changing essential that transforms your iPhone into a handheld console, so you can play anywhere, anytime, all that. Simply plug in your iPhone to the Backbone and enjoy console quality controls with responsive buttons and triggers, clickable analog sticks, and more as you play Xbox, PlayStation, PC, and App Store games. This thing lets you take your gaming anywhere. Backbone lets you explore thousands of worlds from Elden Ring to Minecraft to Call of Duty to all that. If you don't own a console, no problem. Stream hundreds of games like FIFA, Halo, Minecraft, and more through cloud gaming services like Xbox Game Pass, NVIDIA's GeForce Now, and Google Stadia. And even if you already have a PlayStation, Xbox, or PC, play games you own with Remote Play or the Steam Link app. Go to playbackbone.com/TPain now to order your Backbone until June 30th and get free access to over 350 console games and perks, including 1 month free of Xbox Game Pass Ultimate, 1 month free of Apple Arcade, 2 months free of Google Stadia Pro, and 3 months free of Discord Nitro. Find your next adventure at playbackbone.com/TPain. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Tip! What is up with a Tiffany Haddish album? Because I know that you can sing, and I have done music with you remotely.
Mm-hmm.
And I wouldn't mind hearing some original shit, and I know you want to do it.
Well, you know, I'm all about, you know, opportunity and abundance,
right? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And like, how can I benefit my community in the process of creating my shit?
Right.
So, I've been making music. I just did a song with E-40 and
what the fuck?
E-40.
So there is an album coming.
No.
Are you just doing music?
I just make songs and then I put them in my movies. You ain't noticed that?
What?
Yeah.
Because you know, I don't want to necessarily, have to go on tour. I got a song with Jadakiss as well. Like, I don't want to have to go on tour and be like, da, da, da. Like, and you know, I like to do my comedy show, go on tour doing my comedy.
And then
my songs play. What are you talking about? People's paying crazy money for these tickets to come to the comedy show.
You can charge double. Now you can charge comedy show and concert after this. You want to stay for the second show.
Oh, my God. I can't do that. That's too much.
Just do Vegas. Just do a Vegas show.
Vegas, you can do that in Vegas.
Do a Vegas.
I mean, I could do that in Vegas, but I don't want to. I'd rather the movie, the monies go, the music.
Come on, here we go. One of these M words.
All the M's. I'd rather the music go in the movies, mm-hmm. right? And then, like I said, I want to do 50 movies before I turn, like 80 movies or 50 movies before I turn 50.
80 right? movies before you turn 50.
No, it's 50 movies before I turn 50.
Where'd the 80 just come from?
I don't know. Maybe it is 80. Shit.
I'm 80 tipsy. Movies before you turn. You want to be Samuel L. Jackson?
No, I don't want to be Samuel L. Jackson. Somebody just told me a story about him the other day that he like held his college professors hostage or
yes,
some shit.
That was shit was hilarious.
What? Wait, what the fuck happened?
Wait, who was it though? It was like somebody crazy. It was, I think it was like fucking Martin Luther King daddy or somebody. Like it was somebody
what
crazy
college,
like that.
What college?
I can't remember.
At Morehouse.
But he held them hostage and then one of the people was like somebody. Like
for what? Like what did he want?
It was like a protest. It was like a, you know, obviously it was a racism thing. Okay. that nigga been fucking 60 years old for fucking 20 years.
20 years. Man, him and Morgan Freeman, they don't age. They say they've been old since they started, nigga.
Yeah, but when Morgan Freeman was young, it looked like he was trying to disguise himself as old Morgan Freeman.
Yeah, it did look like that.
It's not me.
It's not me. So it's old Morgan Freeman. But no, yeah, but, so you want to do a bunch of movies.
Yeah, and I don't necessarily want to be in all the movies, but I want to produce and give opportunities to people like myself coming up, you know, so... but I still want my fingerprint on the movie. So like maybe I didn't write it. Maybe I'm not directing it. Maybe I'm producing, but also I put my song in it. So my voice is still present because I have a very distinctive voice.
Yeah, absolutely. For sure.
Yeah. Okay. So if you want to make some songs together, I have some ideas. Let me pull out my phone.
Okay. We're going to make sure. Okay. But okay. So with those ideas, give us
the Nappy Boy Radio Song of the Week.
Song of the Week. Song of the Week. Song of the Week.
What's the song of the week? Any song from a history of time. Could be from the motherfucking
definitely got to be history.
Blondie, One Way or Another.
Okay, I wasn't ready for that. Hold on. Give me 1 second. I got to pull
is that from like the 1900s or 1900s?
Another, I'm going to find you. I'm going to get you one way. Maybe next week, I'm going to meet you. I'm going to meet you.
Is that because your friends just came from a drag show? That's not like a drag song.
No, that's one of my favorite songs. It's like on some stalker shit, but not. And you know what else? No, wait, hold up, wait, no, wait. Janis Joplin.
Hold on.
Take another little piece of my heart.
Wait, Janis.
Janis Jalapa. Piece of my heart.
Janis Jalapa.
Jalapia. This is my shit.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
This is my shit.
This is
the Nappy Boy Radio Song of the Week.
See what happens.
Yeah. Tiffany Haddish album will be coming out December 3rd.
What would you call your album though? What would you call your album?
Tiffany, nigga.
Tiffany is cute.
I would call my album I Curse You With Joy. Oh no, that's the next book that's coming
cute,
out.
Though.
That's my next book coming out.
I see
out.
How you tried to can do that. That was slick.
I Curse You With Joy. Goddamn book coming out.
I put a curse on you in the beginning of the thing.
I put a spell
damn.
On you.
Yeah, I'll sing that.
I think that's fair for anybody. Well,
I put a curse. Curse you with success. I curse you with success and joy
speaker
and pit. Abundance and
speaker.
Happiness, unless you a raggedy ass dude.
Oh. I mean, raggedy niggas deserve some kind of love.
No, they don't.
Nah. They at least deserve to be the top.
Nah, man. if you
damn.
They can be the top.
No, they can be the bottom hoe.
No, they can't be the bottom.
But never the top.
They can be the top.
The bottom.
No, the bottom. Raggedy at the top.
No, the raggedy worked the top. Ho worked the hardest out of all the hoes.
The top hoe,
the bottom hoe,
the top.
The top
is the field nigga.
Pimps up, hoes down.
The bottom hoe is the house.
So the pimp nigga is the raggedy nigga.
No.
What?
No.
She said, I said,
have you not
seen? The top niggas is the field niggas.
That was the field
so
niggas.
The bottom one
is the house niggas.
Oh, that's how
it is. Now I'm going to teach you about this afterwards.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, you never heard a pimp say, this is my bottom bitch. That means that's the
main one.
The bottom bitch is the top bitch.
That's the close, yeah.
That's the one he actually has sex with.
I had to watch. What's that movie?
You know what? Before we get let's just before we get too far into this, that was Tiffany Haddish song of the week.
That was a revelation.
Damn. With, you know what? It's Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. We'll be
you know you got it if it makes you feel good.
Yeah, we're gonna figure this out at some point. Ladies and gentlemen, the Road to Wisconsin tour is coming up very soon.
Yeah.
Absolutely, thank you. Right. Yeah.
Sir, I heard you doing a carnival or some shit.
Yeah, we're doing a festival. All right, here we go. This one's gonna be difficult.
Right? I gotta start wearing more diamonds.
You think so?
You are the diamond.
I'm a Tiffany. I'm a Tiffany. I'm the appearance of
the God. I think you need one diamond.
I have a big diamond earring with a bunch of diamonds. Got like 85 diamonds in it.
Damn.
They go on my. But it's I'm scared to wear it anywhere.
I mean, you just gotta wear it to meetings and shit.
I don't even want to wear it to meetings because I feel like the shit's bigger than my head.
Now that you done cut your hair, you're like, God damn, my head is
bigger than it was. Even when I had all the hair, it's like the most expensive thing I got. And I feel like it's just, I just leave it in the safe. I'm going to the Oscars. And I'm like, should I wear these?
Hell yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And then I'm thinking to myself, but they so big.
Wait, is this two?
It's two earrings.
Oh, yeah. No, I thought you said you had one, like, fucking.
Right,
like,
no, I thought it was one, earring. Two.
Turbo from breaking.
It's one
Michael
set.
Jordan, not one earring.
No, it's one set. It's one pair. It's one pair. And I just feel like, I guess if it's the right dress, but it's huge. I bought it at Rihanna's Diamond Ball.
Okay.
Right before just, the.
I be ran
and I, it was an auction going on, and I
sex,
just.
Time to have sex.
To these niggas I wasn't broke.
Yeah.
I'm like, I ain't broke.
If you pay it, so it got to it say it. What you say, Payne?
Mm-hmm.
If you pay it,
it's got to say
it. There it
come
is.
On, somebody. That part.
All right, so I bid it on it. I won the auction. And then I was like, what the fuck did I just do? And then I got the earrings and I put them on and they were so big.
Are they heavy?
Can I borrow them?
Yes, it hurts
did
my
you mean, did you, straight up, did you mean to get them?
Yeah, because I wanted to prove to like, it was three guys there that I kind of had a crush on. And I wanted them to know. And I should have acted broke. I probably could have fucked all three of them if I would have acted more broke.
You.
One of them had bought me some underwear.
You probably could have fucked all three of them and didn't have to buy shit.
That's what I'm learning. But you know, I'm so used to competing with men. That's my problem.
How much was it?
They was expensive.
You thought somebody was gonna outbid you. You just wanted to get up there.
No, I didn't just get up there. I was like $1,000 more, $100 more, $50 more.
You thought somebody was gonna get that one last one. You're like, fuck.
And I got it though.
Motherfucker said going once. He said going once now. I had the money.
But it was just like, damn. You know, damn.
So is that like the most expensive thing you ever bought?
No, the most expensive thing I ever bought was the house next door to the other house.
Come on.
Don't play with it. Fuck them reparations. I'm gonna buy it my damn self.
Yeah, I ain't fucking with that. Look, I got land in Africa and all that. I ain't fucking around.
Come on.
I'm a goddamn queen.
Okay. Shout out to the motherland.
Shim,
shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, shim, sh
that ain't shit. That's just tips. That's just tips. That's just tips. And I got a lot more in my pocket. Somebody better stop it. That ain't shit. That's just
Tiffany.
Truth.
Button game.
Did you guys know that the T in TPain stands for Tiffany? Did you guys know that? I don't know if you guys knew that.
His lawyer gonna beat
your
ass.
His name is Tiffany. Did you know that the Tiffany company was started by two brothers with the last name Tiffany?
Oh, I didn't know
and
that.
And did you know that Tiffany means the appearance of God and or gods?
Mm. And
to or. Sparkle, to shine.
Oh, that's pretty goddamn cool. I thought it was started.
To be the light, to reflect.
I thought it was started by
to reflect the light. Did you know that the Tiffany Company back in the 1800s?
That's a long time.
When it started.
Mm-hmm.
1836, I believe. When it started, they made keys
right.
to locks. They were originally locksmiths.
I don't think that's right.
And they made locks to slaves' chains.
I'm not sure. You got me
sure
fucked. You got me fucked up.
I'm not sure that's right.
Is that true?
If anybody buying Tiffany,
Google that shit. Somebody Google it right now. Fact check that shit. Fact check my shit.
I think you know very well.
Pan gonna fact check
right
your ass right now. She gonna make sure that Tiffany got it. Go ahead.
Did you know that? Did you see in the Tiffany bracelets? You know, and they have the hearts with the little
and
key.
The locks. I knew you was gonna say that. Lock. I knew you was gonna say that.
Baby, that's for the house niggas collar. Am I lying?
That's not true.
I was right. 1837.
Wow, that's
crazy. And what was they making?
iPad.
That nigga got the iPad Pro, motherfucker.
Okay, let's get it.
Because I'm the appearance of guys. I'm here to bring the truth.
Let's get it.
You sparkling on them, too.
Here we go.
Tiff Payne.
Here we go.
Tiffany.
Mm-hmm.
A man comes to your front door.
Oh, yes.
It's not like Cheetos.
No, this is supposed to be like that scary movie.
It is. A man comes to your front door.
Mm-hmm.
In his hand, he has a box.
Ooh.
He says, Tiffany,
mm-hmm.
I have a proposition here.
Mm.
In this box, there's a button.
Y'all niggas is rich.
Mm-hmm. Button box.
Tiffany, if you hit this button, you can have anything you want in the world. Any tangible material thing. But you only get one of it, and it only happens once. Tiffany, when you hit that button, you get that thing. But someone in the world is gonna die. Now, Tiffany, I know what you're thinking. I have everything I want. It's nothing. So what do you mean? I just won't hit the button. Tiffany, I got bad news for you. If you don't hit the button, I will promptly close the box, take the box, and kill PJ. Tiffany, what is that one thing you would want that could save your friend's life and kill another? But also, you get that one thing, so, you know, whatever. Let us know what that one thing is, Tiffany. Come on.
I want a resort in Eritrea, right off the coastline of the Red Sea, where black people can go and feel beautiful and rest and be at peace. And do you know who's gonna die?
Well, we're not supposed to know who dies.
Oh, okay. Oh. Yeah.
So that's, you can't pick.
She can't choose.
Oh, I can't pick who dies.
Game.
I can't pick who dies. No, what the fuck? You can't come to my house. Tell me somebody gotta fucking die. Sir.
There has to be a variable.
I'm controlled.
Sir.
Sir.
Sir, I'm about to snatch your soul, sir. Sir, I'm about to get on your last nerve. You're gonna take your box and get the fuck out. Sir. Sir. Sir, I know what the fuck I want, sir. Sir.
Sir.
Where's the button?
Sir.
Sir,
who dies, sir? Sir, who dies? Sir, you know what? Fuck that resort, sir. Kill yourself.
But wait a
minute. So you're not hitting the button, you're going to kill PJ?
I'm going to hit the button, goddamn.
Wait. What'd you say?
I said, you're going to kill PJ?
No, I'm going to hit the button, but okay. I want the resort.
Okay.
Who's going to die, though?
Here's the people that can die.
Okay.
A 25-year-old jogging down the street, perfect health, having a good old day. Enjoy. Oh, I just had my avocado toast and my flat white from Starbucks. Oh, it's a great day. But guess what? Tiffany Haddish won a motherfucking resort. Boom! Ow! Heart attack. It's over. You could kill second Hitler. You might do some good. Who knows? Never know. You also could kill a motherfucking baby.
When?
What kind of baby? A baby duck? A baby.
A human baby?
Yes, one of those.
A human baby?
Whose baby is it?
It's not a baby snake?
We just don't know.
I don't know nobody pregnant. It can be okay, keep going.
Any type of baby. Any type of baby.
All we know is anybody in the world could die.
Mm-hmm.
Could be me. I'm a random person. He's a random person. You don't want him
here
to
die.
Here
goes the thing.
Okay.
We are going to die.
Yeah, but none of us are going to die when you hit this fucking button.
Somebody might die because I farted, nigga.
No, like, anybody
can die at any time.
No, here's the thing. When you hit the button, we specifically go and kill somebody because you hit the button.
No, that's not it. But they was going to die anyway. This going
to
bring abundance and prosperity.
Can we kill somebody that's about to die?
I'll say it again.
Can we kill somebody that's about to die, like in their suffering?
That's not fair.
Okay.
No.
Why is that not fair? They're already suffering.
That's like a good.
Because they're already dying. It doesn't create anything.
Everybody's already dying. We was born dying, nigga.
Exactly. But I'm saying some are dying.
We can't end suffering.
Some are dying at a slower rate than others.
Negotiate the fuck out of you. Do you understand me?
Some are dying at a slower rate than others.
Yes.
Yes. So it's going to be somebody.
Well, you want to kill a baby. We want to end
you
suffering.
A baby killer,
that's
sir.
Right.
You are all baby ass killer. Look at you. Thinking about
money.
Killing people babies.
They
not even giving a baby a chance. What they going to give him? A cradle?
Is that a B for baby?
What you going to give him?
It's a B on the button. Is that a B for baby?
It's an NB. That's for Nappy Boy. I don't know why that's there.
Oh, okay.
It's just...
No more babies. He's a baby killer.
Baby
Tiffany,
duck.
Tiffany, do you want the resort or do you want to kill your friend?
No, I want the resort.
Okay, we hit the button.
I want the resort.
We hit the button.
It's a double button. It's like an apple button.
Hit the button.
But it's two buttons, stuff. Though.
Hit the button.
But who's going to die?
It's
a button.
My friend ain't going to die.
We will find out.
Now, if I hit the button, you going to kill my friend anyways?
No, not at all.
Because that ain't cool.
That's not
I need to see the contract.
That's not how it works.
I need to go over the contract.
This is the contract. The button is the contract.
No, but I don't see nothing right.
Once you hit the button, your friend is out of the equation.
What happened to the random nigga?
So you promised?
No, I said once she hit the button, the friend is out of the equation.
Okay, and what about anybody that I know personally?
That we can't.
Anybody that I know personally, they out of the question too?
No, we can't guarantee that.
Okay, can we just kill off one of my exes?
That's very possible.
Which one would you kill though?
We can't pick.
Okay, let's start from 2000.
No, let's start from currently to backwards.
Nah, nigga. I wanted to start from 2013 on down, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so 2013 till 1997. Preferably the motherfucker from 96. Can we kill that motherfucker?
Yeah,
I'll build two resorts to kill him and his daddy.
Can we put a location?
What did his dad do?
Oh, he had him.
His dad gave birth to that nigga.
That's a crime.
Oh, my God.
Now we're making deals.
The mom didn't have a choice. She was a Jehovah's Witness. Yep, we going with that.
Okay, well,
all right, you laugh. That means I get to kill him and his daddy.
Okay, Tiffany agreed that she would strangle a baby with her bare hands to get a resort.
A baby snake.
And what is it?
If it's my ex from 97 as a baby, I would strangle that motherfucker. Or my ex from 2008.
What the fuck is this?
We can strangle
episode?
Him as a baby.
Bro, so what they is, couldn't hear is, none of that, could they?
What is the whole hell
That's
is this
crazy.
Episode?
Crazy. They couldn't hear
that.
They didn't understand why I was laughing so fucking hard.
No, it was a lot going on there.
God damn.
That was crazy.
That was an adventure.
But I negotiated the fuck out of you.
It was good. Yeah, y'all did that shit.
This is stuff we was testing before y'all got in here.
Yeah, y'all did that shit.
We started adding shit. Ladies and gentlemen, the production value of the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
Damn!
It's up.
Tremendously. Thank you.
It better not.
Yesterday's price is not today's price.
Yeah, we couldn't slack on Tiffany. I'll tell you that shit right now.
Out of bill.
Better have.
We've been trying to get this motherfucker. for like 3 months, ain't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, I've been.
I mean, I've been here since October.
Yeah, it's kind of been, it's been my fault. It's been my fault the whole time. All right. I've been getting sick and shit. I didn't want to get nobody sick. Oh, yeah. So yeah, that was the button question. Tiffany wanted a resort. Mm-hmm. Where is it?
In Eritrea.
Just for black people.
Well.
What about interracial couples?
Yeah, that's okay.
All right, yeah. We did it. All right.
That's okay, because once, you know, well, if it's male, it doesn't matter.
You got to see W-2s before you
get W-2s. Well, I want, if it's an interracial couple, that means they're cool with, you know, the blackness or whatever. You know, I want it to be a place where, you know, you feel comfortable being who you are.
You want a Wakanda resort? Mm.
And it's not a Wakanda, I wouldn't say, but you know, yeah, basically.
They let some white people in there.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't block white people. I would just block certain types of people.
Mm. What about mixed people?
Mixed people can come.
Beige babies. Oh, yeah. What's the age range in the resort?
Oh, all ages. Zero, all ages? 0 to 1,000.
Oh, so it's not a hedonism there?
1,000?
No, we got out of hedonism on the other side. Wait. That's when they get butt naked and shit, right? Yeah. That's what I want. But they're not going to allow that there.
You have a daycare?
Oh, really? They wouldn't?
I mean, I guess we could. I mean, we got to block off a certain part.
I feel like you represent. And you
but
can,
have you seen me naked anywhere? Nigga?
I'm just saying. I'm just saying they'll let you do whatever over there. I'm just saying.
And I don't think they would let me do whatever, but they would let me get away with a lot. But I would do, like, I would block off a certain section of the beach where you could be, because I like to be naked in the sun. Mm-hmm. Okay. In the back, especially when I was bald headed. That shit was dope. But there's more hair on my coochie than it was on my head.
What?
That shit was popping, nigga.
Well, that's if you guys want to sign up to be the first occupants of Haddish Hotels.
Haddish Hotel and Resort.
Haddish Hotel and Resort.
And I got an island. Caption. I got an island out there, but the problem with the island is when the sea rises, it covers the island.
You ain't account for high tide out that motherfucker.
Well, I didn't get to pick it. I didn't get to pick the island. It was assigned to me. But,
giving out islands out that motherfucker?
You gotta be a special type of nigga.
Damn. Hey. Come on, flip.
And I didn't say
time to have sex.
But I didn't say that. Just giving it to me.
Oh, okay.
You gotta
that makes
earn
sense.
You gotta earn your shit. But this off the coast of Eritrea, there's over 300 islands. So
that's available or that's been taken?
That's
so when
they're
is
there.
It when
they're
does available. The tide rise? Is it every day or is it like a season?
It's pretty much on a daily basis, but if you go like it rises, and there's still a little peak of the island where you can put like a gazebo and you could chill.
This is one.
And I went.
Oh shit! The water coming. Get out. We done.
The
water.
You gotta get an alarm system.
It's not that big. It's like the size of a football field. But
that's
a football field ain't that big.
The water. I mean, a lot of niggas can live there on a football field.
Water come up. You got 20 square feet left in that motherfucker. You got to fucking figure it out. Everybody group up.
You
group
got 50
up.
Yards. You got basically 50 yards. And when I remember we was there and there was like, it was a, what you call them things? Mm-hmm. Cement? No, what the fuck is it called?
A stingray.
A stingray had washed up on the shore and it was dead.
Oh. Damn.
But I thought to myself, my island has life around it.
Sure. Did you eat that fucking stingray? Sure,
I didn't eat that stingray. Bet I got some bomb ass boots. Waste not, want not.
That was the goddamn question.
God brought that stingray to me for a reason.
That was Tiffany Haddish's button question. God damn it, we gonna get the fuck out of here in a second, then we gonna put that back because you obviously abused that motherfucker.
What do you mean I abused it? This is going to create thousands of jobs. This is going to be prosperity to a whole country.
You can't pick one of your niggas to die.
Why? You let me.
I know. You're special. All right. That was Tiffany Addis' button question. It's Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. We will be... Tiffany, hit the button.
Shut it down.
They're back.
It's up, huh?
Guys, go pre-order my new book. Look at this shit. You know what I had to fight for in this fucking book? And I'm so glad that I held my ground on this. Because it was just going to be a normal joint. See how that looks? Now, what you can't tell is that all the pages are black with gold writing. Look at that. I'm so glad I held my foot on this. Look at that. Oh, All the pages are black.
It's gorgeous.
I put my book in dark mode for y'all. You see what I did? Now if that don't deserve a pre-order, I put my book in dark mode for everybody. If y'all could just go pre-order this, make this a bestseller, man. I want to have a bestseller. And it's not something that you necessarily have to read. I gave two of these to my kids today, and my daughter was like, I don't drink, but I'll take one. I know you don't drink. What are you talking about?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Hell yeah, Tiffany Haddish and his motherfucking fool, peas in his bitch.
In his motherfucking,
you know what I'm saying?
You trying to start some shit.
Just
because your eyebrows touch don't mean you got to start
God
shit.
Oh, God damn it. Jesus Christ.
That was spicy.
Yeah, that was nice. Tip.
Damn. Get this nigga some tweezers.
Tiffany.
You pluck that shit okay. Right there. I'm going to pluck my mustache.
It's on you. I'm going to leave it. Ooh. Good. I'm glad you.
Tiffany.
I'm glad you noticed that.
I know I got a mustache. Okay. I got high testosterone levels.
Okay.
You know what they say about women with high testosterone levels?
No, I don't. I never remember.
Fuck
one.
The yeah, dog I'm, shit out of you.
Okay,
nigga.
That makes sense. Oh. Tiffany Haddish, welcome to
Make You Cry When You Come, nigga.
Oh, what?
Damn. Damn.
I don't sound like a goal. That's not
that's her goal, obviously.
That's not something I'm striving for. Tiffany Haddish.
Never forget it.
Tiffany Haddish.
Yes, sir.
Welcome to the Trap Spelling Bee.
Wow.
You get almost done. I promise you.
She says she got to go to work in the morning. God damn it.
I got to make money. I make millions.
I got you. I got
Ooh,
you.
Shit.
I'll be going hey, to sleep at your call time.
I'm going
to
be that top hole.
Now he want to get his middle, eyebrows pulled. Then yeah, the nigga want to cry.
I'm going to be all the
you
holes
you got to get that Black
want,
History
God
Report
damn.
Ready, though.
All right. Here we go. Tip. Okay. This is the Trap Spelling Bee. It's the same rules as a regular spelling bee. You can ask for a definition. You can ask for a place of origin. Use it in a sentence. All the regular shit. you can also ask for a lifeline. Now, I'm going to tell you what the lifeline is. It's just the couch. Only people on the couch.
What about me? Can't be like
No. It's
my
only
cousin on the
because
couch.
Because you're going to be able to see the word.
Oh, am I?
Yeah, because I'm going to be facing this way to
well,
work.
I'm going
to
be
back. My cousin on the couch. My cousin on the couch.
Absolutely. Yeah, so you may have some help.
My cousin Cherry in the building.
I will tell you, Cash is the champion of the Trap Spelling Bee so far.
Look at this nigga here.
And we've had a lot of these. So.
No, thank you.
Before we get started, Tip, I got to know where you're from and what school you represent. What school did you learn how to spell from?
I'm from Los Angeles, California.
Uh-huh.
South Central Los Angeles, to be exact, and I was bused. I had to get up every morning at 4:45 and ride the school bus to Woodland Hills, California, to El Camino Real High School, where I finally learned how to read.
In West Philadelphia, born and raised.
No, South Central Los Angeles, born and raised on the school buses where I spend most of my days riding
and
out to Woodland Hills, getting that shit. At least 2 hours, bitch.
4:45.
That's early.
That's why I know how to wake up early. That's why I know how to wake up early now and get my money.
Bam. That's how you do
that's
that.
That's why I need me a husband.
Better fucking pound that. That's
house
what the fuck
husband,
I'm talking about.
House husband.
Don't be acting like that in the public, okay? I'm sorry.
You got to.
Don't make me have to butt. I'm not going to slap you. I would never slap you, but I'll pinch the dog shit out of you.
I'm not going to hurt you, but I'm going to hurt you.
I'm sorry.
All right.
I'm sorry.
Now, Tip, now when we do this, when you're ready for the word, I'm going to give you the word, but you got to say the word, then spell the word, and to lock it in.
Get a definition?
You got to say the word again. So if I give you what, you go, what? W-H-A-T. What? And then I can tell you if you're right or wrong.
Okay.
Cool?
How many chances do I get?
You have 5 words.
I have to spell 5 words.
Yeah, if you get 3 out of 5, you probably get stuff.
Come on, verbal advantage.
The good news is this is the trap
the
spelling bee.
The easy way to get an A.
This is the trap spelling bee.
Oh, so I can spell it phonetically?
Spell it the way the trap would spell it. The way it's spelled in the trap.
Ah, shit.
Oh, wait, what?
If you give me if and I spell it E-F.
Yeah.
If.
Yeah.
If, that. E-F, if.
Right.
That's how you
that
spell it.
That means you make the letter sound however you
actually,
want it to
okay. Actually,
now, if you need a lifeline, it's only the couch.
Sounds like.
It's
I got
if.
But you can make any letter sound however you want.
But he's going to
really.
Say it.
I'm going to say it exactly how it is on the fucking thing. Mm-hmm. Keep in mind, you can ask for the definition. You can ask for a fucking sentence. Some of these you can use it in, use it in a song lyric.
Okay.
So, here we go.
Help me, don't help me.
No, don't help her.
Are you ready?
If you help her, I'm going to punch
Tip,
you.
Tip, are you ready for
she
the trap spelling bee?
We're going to put
5 words on the motherfucking shit right now. Tiffany.
Yes.
Spell throwed.
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 Throwed. Throwed. T-H. O-A-D. Throwed.
Wrong. Super fucking wrong.
Wait, who decides how to spell it?
The card.
The trap?
The card.
The card.
But who put that
It's
there?
The card. I don't give a fuck who wrote this. It's the card.
Cause E instead of an A?
Yeah, because throw rhymes with toad.
Toe.
So she right.
I mean, there's a. I mean, yeah. I mean,
what if it's another trap outside of this one? It's a different trap.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So there's that. So yeah, whatever.
It's this wrong. Man mad over
but
here.
But I get it.
He over here in his goddamn feelings.
Toe rhymes with toe.
No, you should. You
they
should
spell
be
it like
lucky.
A toe.
Shit, he the one.
They spell it like a toe.
Like
what's
a toe,
the definition
like a
is? This drink got me throwed.
If I,
that's,
if
a,
I,
e. that's a sentence.
If throw I, with if, an E. If so I, you
I'm so throwed in
e.
the game. Southside players, screw the click main. H-A-W-K. Throwed in the game. Yeah, I'm insane. Call me Tiffany. I'm drinking my thing. Yeah, I'm all throwed up in the game.
Hey.
Niggas try to play, but ooh. They can't play me. Cause I'm the baddest chick that you ever did see. Keep your face. Never would have known it was me until I step up on the carpet in my diamond earrings.
Rings!
Popping and I get that shit.
Shit.
Yeah, I'm really rich.
Rings!
Got my own island in the motherfucking Africa. Got my.
Y'all niggas rich for real. God damn. I'm glad to be a top hoe, bottom hoe, any hoe you want me to be.
All right, Tim.
Okay, next word.
You ready
word,
for the next one?
Word, next word.
All right. Tip, spell Zaddy.
You got it. You got
Zaddy.
If I
was you, I would just ask for all the shit you can do.
Yeah. Can I get it in a definition, please?
A handsome gentleman with a certain flair and swag.
Oh, really? I like that.
Okay, now get the song lyric for it, please.
How's he calling me Zaddy?
She keeps on. That, right there.
How's he calling me Zaddy?
That, right there.
Zaddy. Zaddy. Z-A-D-D-Y. Zaddy. Ooh, I need my Zaddy. Come on, Zaddy. Come on, Zaddy. Zaddy, take me off to school.
Make sure you
Zaddy,
show that, cause Zaddy, you was Zaddy, you Zaddy, wanted Zaddy, that, you really wanted Zaddy, her to Zaddy, have that wrong.
Zaddy,
you wanted her to have that motherfucker wrong.
You think I'm there? You not right.
How can you spell that?
But you give me the Zaddy for tonight.
You know I'm Zaddy.
Where the
Zaddy be Zaddy?
Yeah, I'm Zaddy. Yeah,
bring that
I'm Zaddy, 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 Zaddy. I'm Zaddy. Yeah, I'm Zaddy. Yeah, I'm Zaddy. Yeah, I'm Zaddy.
Okay.
That shit's bothering me.
Here we go.
You all right.
You ready?
I love it. I'ma kiss it later. Who cheating?
I gotta find a good angle, cause I'm
in his feelings
ain't
over here.
Doing
this
that.
Nigga got his beads from Ghana.
First of all, Zaddy is not a hard word. It rhymes
from Ghana.
With Daddy.
He in his feelings.
Like, okay. Come on now.
Tip, you ready for the next one?
Okay, don't ever take it off.
You ready for the next one?
Yeah, she ready.
Tiffany!
I'm about to have a fight with your friend.
Spell ganja.
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 Ooh. Ganja.
Ganja.
Oh.
Ganja.
Ganja. I need all them.
Nah. Give it to me in a definition.
Marijuana.
Give it to me in a lyric.
I thought you said acadia.
There's no lyrics.
Give it to me in a sentence.
Pass me the ganja.
Ganja. The way I would spell it is G U. No, wait. Ganja. G. Oh.
Hold on. Can I don't want to interrupt you. I don't want to interrupt
you.
You're doing it. Okay.
You're doing it.
I know. But you got options.
Yeah.
So if you need to slide to the left.
Yeah.
To them three folks over there, you got. I mean, just go ahead and talk. You know
what I mean?
You
feel me?
I mean, I ain't trying to. You know what I mean?
How many times can she ask the couch?
She can ask the couch as much as she wants. It's what she comes back with. Whatever one that you think is the right one, if you come back with that one, nothing is locked in until you say the word, spell the word, and then say the word. So you can ask as many people
delegation,
as you want.
Please. G-A-N-J-A. That's not the hood way of spelling it, though. Everybody spell like that.
Not G-H. All right, ganja. G-A-N-J-A.
Hey! You see what?
Hey! You getting cool now.
Hey!
Hey!
You can just say just use all your options. If you got options, use your options,
now,
my people. You got options.
I would have said... Huh?
He's trying to get you to
against my black man. I might talk shit to you, but I'm always going to follow. That's my job.
I fuck with that shit. I'm going to challenge you. I'm going to talk shit to you, but I'm going to follow you. That makes sense.
And then I'm going to be singing the Janis Joplin song. Take another little piece of my heart now, baby.
Come on.
All right. You got two out of five so far.
Hey.
If you get three... You're pretty much up there. You're up there in the ranks. You ready for the next one?
Yes.
Tiffany Haddish, spell I.
Woo. Oh, come on.
Just remember what I told you. All I'm saying is
delegation.
Just
delegation.
You got options now. Can you? I actually want to hear you. Can you say it one more time?
Is it like from the South or the West Coast or what?
Yeah, because I
is, there you got is, options.
So each thing has a place of origin.
Right. Yes. So where's the origin? Oh, place of origin, please.
Unknown.
Oh! Oh my God! You can't do it.
That's what the card says.
Just make them say it again.
Do they all say it?
Say it again, please.
I like that.
I.
Definition.
I.
Okay, all right.
Everything's gonna be all right.
And can I hear you use it in a lyric?
I.
No.
I hit the gate and I hops on my Schwinn and I tell the homies I then.
Ooh.
Warren G.
Ooh.
And Warren G from where? Where Warren G from?
The West Coast, baby.
Thank you.
Hey, y'all did good with these sound effects shits.
It's gonna cut down on like 2 hours of my editing.
Nice.
It's gonna be great.
I'm about to.
Is this too loud? Is this too loud, Chris? It's loud?
Help me.
It's a little bit. It's a little loud. Okay. Yeah. Next episode, we'll figure it out.
It ain't too loud. It ain't too loud for me.
Okay.
Now I'm gonna go with.
Was that all her options? Though we did
you
all
told
of
me
them.
I can
we did
see
all
it,
of
now
them.
I can't see it.
I
just want to make sure we went through all of them because I just.
Huh?
How many left?
I.
This one and another.
I.
Help me.
I.
H. No, wait, but no, but I.
I.
A. No, 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 wait, no, wait. I. I. No, wait. I. G-H-T.
What?
No, no, wait, no, no, no.
What did the couch say?
I.
Can you say it one more time for her, please?
I.
You kind of cleared your throat. Could you just say it one more time?
I.
Why can't Kishi?
I would spell it I G H. Huh? What'd you say?
She's seen the car.
AIDS.
She's seen the car.
What you say, Kevin?
If it's said,
everybody knows.
I said.
Yes.
That's what I think it is
too. She saw
the car. That's what
all
I would think it is. I had some niggas text me this.
Let me just tell you.
And I was like, what the fuck does this?
Let me just tell you something. Let me just tell you something real quick.
All right.
Yo. Tip.
All right.
Tip. This nigga's trying to get you to not have the high score, right?
Right. Don't trust him. Trust your cousin. And when it's, trust your cousin.
All right.
Trust your cousin.
My cousin spell. My cousin been reading the Bible for a long time.
I don't think that word is in there.
Alright.
I don't think that word is in there.
But I'ma go with.
Alright, let there be.
Alright.
Light.
I'ma go with A-I-G-H. I-T.
What?
Yes, sir. Yeah, say it. At the end, yes, sir.
Wait, do it again.
A-I. All right. I.
See, trust your cousin.
A-I-G-H-T. I.
What?
You actually had it right when you said it the first time.
I.
Yeah.
That's not true. That's not true.
You had it right.
Damn.
Yeah, that was fucked up. Damn, son.
That's what you get for listening to people
eyes?
Sometimes.
That is not true.
But
you
know what? He put it. She spelled it. She did it.
But
she said it.
Two eyes is not
I did
true.
Say it earlier.
It's on the card. I'm not spelling this shit. I don't make these cards.
Actually,
it's
actually.
I.
It's kind of true.
It's not true. It's I. It's A-I-G-H-T.
It's kind of true if you say it like that.
Nobody said
she just did it.
You say it like this.
I.
I
did it.
I spelled it.
Yeah. I just spelled it, nigga.
She spelled it like that. She actually had
okay,
it right.
Bring on the next
time.
One. Bring on the next
the
one.
The first time she did it, she actually spelled it right, but she didn't like it.
She like, fuck this shit. Bring the next shit on. I know how to do it.
You ready? You ready for the next one?
Serious citizen arm wrestle.
That's crazy.
Serious. Now you serious on the last one? You ready?
Let's go.
That's not true.
You ready?
Come on, let's go.
I.
Can you concuss?
Let's go. Next one.
You actually had it right. I can't believe it.
I doesn't make
Tiffany! Spell.
That's a good one.
Can you say it again for me?
Wait, what?
And
we don't use symbols in this. Can we use symbols? Like how Prince
the dash,
was like
dash.
A circle.
What's place of origin?
Place of origin.
Instagram.
Black mothers.
Ooh. Use it in a sentence.
Put that down.
Ain't none of y'all got no mothers like that. Y'all too young. Y'all got no mothers like that.
They still like that. You promise?
I mean, you got options. Just remember that you can ask
trust
him. He got a couple more ways. You could just make him say it again if I was you. I mean, that's how we got the last
how we
one.
We know he sounded it out right, though.
No, he sounded all of them all right. If you look at that card.
A-H-T.
Whoa. I ain't saying
that.
That
sound
right to me.
That was locked?
A-H-T. I'ma grease your scalp, nigga.
Yeah.
I got some shea butter in my little hand.
So what part of the album?
I got shea butter in this little.
What part do he get? Helena. What part do he get to be on the guy?
I got some shea butter in this Helena Ferreira handbag.
That's three.
Black on.
Damn. That's 3 out of 5. Hey,
Black owned that company.
Good. That's 3 out of 5, ladies and gentlemen.
Yo.
Helena Ferreira.
That's 3 out of 5. Young Cass is still the remaining champ.
Since we doing ghetto terms in this motherfucker, I want to go ahead and give a shout out to the sucker. Helena Ferreira. Harris.
Now, because
Black
you
designer
got...
Black designer Harris.
Because you got 3 out of 5, that means you actually won the fucking game, which means you get a copy of the game, the Trap Spelling Bee. You get a copy of my book, Can I Mix You a Drink? And you get your own Nappy Boy Radio.
Now, what is this book about? Because I actually read books.
You're going to want to read this a lot. There's a lot of 50 drink recipes from my life.
Drink recipes?
Yeah, that's my new book. Yeah.
Now, you got to do, if you're going to do the next book, do the drink.
My next book is a cookbook.
Okay, so with every recipe, tell a story.
That's what's in there. It's 50 recipes for my life and career. So there's stories.
It's
that
a story.
They're
so short.
Yeah, I know, because it's, because people want to get to the drinking and not so much as the thinking.
They're short.
Yeah, it's real shit. It's like drink etiquette and shit like that. But yeah.
This is too short, bruh.
I know, but the next one is gonna be good. The next one is a cookbook. It's called Stressipes and Struggle Plates.
I like stress.
Okay, so you gonna have a cup of noodles with the hot links in there?
It's gonna be
hot links.
It's gonna be
like
iron.
Hot dogs.
It's gonna be iron.
I put hot links now.
No, man. Hot dogs, hot links.
Iron bologna sandwiches and stuff like that.
Oh, my God, I love bologna. I miss bologna so much. I haven't had it in years.
Yeah, so it's going to be stuff like you said. It's going to be like hot dogs and ramen noodles.
Remember the bologna with the red band?
With the red band.
Yeah, they got chew on those.
Oh, my God.
I'll take those off, chew on those for a whole day.
Yes.
Man, do you remember frying those and they bubble up and then you put the government cheese?
Not government. Government cheese.
The bologna do this?
You put the government cheese? You got government cheese?
Reach for the sky, bologna.
Oh, your mama and daddy had jobs.
But ladies and gentlemen, that was Tiffany Haddish's Spelling Bee. Give it up, goddamn it, she won the goddamn game! Oh my God, 3 out of 5, you did fucking good. You didn't beat Young Cash, but that's because he kept trying to trick you and shit. You actually had four.
No, you did a good job.
But you actually had 4 out of 5, and
that's
goddamn
okay.
you squandered, and that's what happened.
That's
all right. That was Tiffany Haddish Spelling Bee. It's the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I like your book. We will be.
Shut it down.
Right back.
Down.
Thank you.
It looks delicious.
Thank you. And some of these.
What's your favorite drink?
Are these real lemons?
The 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock? What's in it? It's tequila?
It's ice cream in it.
Go ahead and get T-Pain's Nappy Boy Gaming Energy right here.
Oh, what's that?
Are we going to throw an ass
shameless
plug. Passion fruit.
Look at this. Next level. Nappy Boy Gaming. Yeah, if you need energy for this, this is what fuels this.
Okay? There it is.
Dang.
Welcome back to the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. I am your homeboy T-Pain, a.k.a. your girlfriend's boyfriend.
And I am Pip, a.k.a. Mr. Fresh Prince, a.k.a. Mr. God Damn!
Also known as the bottom.
Tiff, you got any of those? You got some of those? You got some AKAs and shit?
AK, what? Oh, do I got AKAs?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. TT, Tiffany City, Tiffy.
Tiffy?
Tiffy.
That's from my
No, that's from my auntie.
That's some slave name.
Tiffy.
Is your auntie mixed?
No. She called me Tiffy. She be like, Tiffany, Tiffy. She goes, Tiffy, do this, Tiffy, do that.
Oh, she rich?
No.
Yeah.
No, quite the opposite.
Also,
she was the bottom.
A lot of kids call me Queen of the Universe. A lot of men call me Queen.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Anybody call you anything from a Lego movie? Anything? Nothing. They just like.
They be like Queen Universe, Queen of the Universe, Queen Wanabi, Queen of Wanabi.
Yeah. Nice.
And because I can be whatever I want to be.
And that's so not me.
Yeah, that's so not me.
You gotta have it. I did four versions of that song.
I did so many versions of it too.
Crazy. I did four versions. Hey, wait, what about the Batman joint?
The Batman's, remember when it was,
I want to hear the Batman song.
Like a romantic thing to a reggae thing to another thing.
Yeah, wait, but did they put them two and two together to see if they was gonna work, or did yours and they was like, yo, this ain't gonna work?
They just kept changing Lego, man. You gotta do. And they say, do another one. Yeah. Yes. Okay.
They kept changing. I had a vocal coach. That's my first time ever having a vocal coach.
I didn't feel like you need a vocal coach. I feel like that.
You know why you didn't feel like I needed one? Because I had one.
Smart. But because you know, people ask me why I never had a vocal coach. I think they'll change my style. I think they'll change my.
They don't change your style.
Sorry. That's your phone.
I need you to calm down a lot. I need you to calm down a bunch.
They don't change your style. Like,
not my style. I just feel like they'd make me sing from a different place, and it'll change my voice. It'll, because guys, I sing from the wrong place. Period. Every show I lose my voice. Every single show.
Well, that's and why I feel you need like a vocal coach.
Yeah, but I'd sing different. I don't want to do that.
No, but see, for me, like, I sing the same, but it don't hurt no more.
Right. You can sing for hours and hours, and hours.
Like,
and hours
I could go. Yeah, I kind of want it to hurt a little bit. Not gonna lie to you.
Because you don't want to work the next day.
No.
Yeah. You
because you don't want to have to have a conversation with your family.
That's a part of it, but I also want you to feel the pain of my voice.
Right. But you can still give them the pain without giving the pain.
Extended pain.
Get up, get
no,
up.
No, I want them to feel that. I want them to feel that. And I don't want them to feel the.
Okay. You know, I want to feel it.
You know, my favorite song.
The E.
I can't stand the rain.
Yeah. Against my window.
I can't stand the rain.
Yeah, that's the difference. With a voice calls, it's against my window. But without that voice calls, you're like, against my window. And you can go there. You can have that. That hard.
But you know you should pull that from your nuts and not your throat.
It is. Dang. It was mostly in my nuts. It hurt a little bit now.
There you go.
Feel it. You know, sometimes you feel like it's a string going from your belly button to your nuts.
That's good. That's when your soul is activated.
There it is. Against my will.
I like how PJ's like, no, that's not correct.
I ain't got no soul. I got no soul.
PJ's face is like, no, that's
you want to smoke with me?
Not correct.
Yeah. You want to smoke with me? Here's what we're gonna do, Tip. We're gonna do your creative curse word of the week.
I'm starting to fall asleep, guys.
This is the last. This is literally the last thing. You've been here for like four hours.
Yeah, you've been here.
This is
way too motherfucking long.
This has not been short.
I gotta get up at 4 hours.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. Oh, what time is it? Oh, yeah, we fucked up. Oh, shit. Okay, Tip. Here's it is. This is your creative curse word book. Now, this book has two sides. Boom. Now, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take this one side. You're gonna go and you're gonna flip and you're gonna stop. That's your random word. You're gonna go to this side. You're gonna stop. Flip that over. That's another random word. Now, there's gonna be two words. That's gonna make your creative curse word of the week. All you gotta do is give us a medium-sized story that ends in these two words, and it's a wrap.
Medium.
I tell you, I know it's time for me to go to bed because I'm getting congested.
Like, you got boo-boo?
Nah, that's congested. Nigga, congested, that's in your face.
Oh, okay.
Not you can't
be a top host.
I'm sorry.
Damn.
I thought congested was like boo-boo.
This is why.
That's why he can't be a top host. You gotta, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know everything.
You got to know your pimp. You got to know what you're talking about.
I'm sorry.
You got to be.
Your top hoe got to know what congested means, for sure.
You ain't even got to know what it means. You just got to know. You got to see her face and be like, hey, it's about time
to
go.
You just have me go.
Yeah. And you got to be like, hey, y'all.
Then he got to be
That's when you got to step in like a publicist and be like, hey, let's go. It's time to wrap it up.
Yeah, that one that's back there taking pictures.
Mother.
This is going to be weird.
Chomper.
Mother Chomper.
A mother Chomper?
Ah, Mother Chomper. Look at this old bucky head ass Mother Chomper.
You got to give us a medium sized story that's going to end with Mother Chomper. Was there any time in your life?
Let me tell you this quick story. It's very quick, okay? Mm-hmm. No time on this story because I got to go to bed. So I was dealing with this dude, right? He told me he ain't got no kids. Turns out this motherfucker got two kids. Right?
Two.
He got two kids.
That's more than
enough. But then I had told him, like, bruh, you told me you didn't have no kids. He said, I know, I got two, though. I said, but you told me you didn't have none at first. He said, I didn't think I had it because, you know, I just used my mouth. I said, you a mother chump?
Okay. I'll give you that one. That, you know what? Hey, ladies and gentlemen. That was a Nappy Boy Radio Podcast.
Mother
Give
Chopper.
It up for Tiffany Haddish.
Yeah. Good job. You don't get it?
Yeah, I got it now.
Okay, it's somebody that have a woman who's had babies. Right. Right. She's a mother.
Yep.
Right. A man who eats.
Amen.
Okay.
Like, you could
I'm
be.
Following.
Like, because I've been a father fucker.
Okay.
Yes, I know.
I'm a father fucker. I have fucked somebody's father.
I'm sure.
Okay. That's a mother chopper.
Gotcha.
Okay, so he chopped somebody's mother.
I'm not. He Pac-Man. He Pac-Man that mama pussy.
I'm not.
Mother chopper.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Look at this old mother chopper in this bitch.
It's the Nappy Boy Radio Podcast. Give it up to Tiffany Haddish one more time.
Choppers.
We'll be back next week. It might be like a greatest hits episode, but guess what? Guys got us covered.
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna figure it out. Thank y'all for coming through. We'll see y'all next week. Peace the fuck out, you pieces of shit. Yeah.
Mighty.
Good shit. Good job.